Ayan! Hello! Good evening to everyone watching here at DTV Pilipinas, FB, YouTube, and also to the YouTube of Sir James, lahat sa mga ating mga viewers. Good evening, and I know na you've been waiting for another DTV Pilipinas live discussion, pero dahil nga sa, of course, sa mga different na happenings na nangyayari ngayon, we are now necessitating going live again para maklaro ang mga issue at ang inyong mga tanong regarding sa mga bagay-bagay na nandito sa panahon ngayon. Of course, I am Red. Of course, ang isa sa mga inyong magiging moderator or host, sabihin na natin. And kasama natin dito si Pat, of course, Pat. And of
yes,
course,
good evening,
Jay.
Good evening.
Yeah. Magandang gabi sa inyo lahat. Mahabang usapan to. So, yung ating kasama dito sa show, may handa ng beer. So, ready na.
May handa ng beer. Kayo dyan, sa view, and of course, ang ating special guest. Hindi kami magla-live kung wala siya. Of course, importante ang kanyang mga inputs later on in a few minutes. Of course, the one and only, sabi na natin, God the Father ba? Father of digital TV in the Philippines. We coined it. Of course, we were the ones who coined it. Si Sir James Rodney Santiago, of course. Hi, Sir James. Good evening sa'yo.
Good evening, guys. It's nice to be back sa stream ng DTV Pilipinas.
Ayan. Okay, so if you have any comments and questions, please put them on the chat box below. Or on the YouTube, sa YouTube live natin, yung dito sa side na to. Tama ba? Tama, side na to.
Oo, tama yan. Tama
and,
yan.
And of course, if you have any questions, we'll try to ask them all later on. And hanggat nandito si Sir James, any questions that you have raised, i-explain natin yan in further detail. So, without further ado, Sir James, ano ang iyong topic natin so we can start the ball rolling?
It's just timely to talk about what's going on and with the recent development of the reassignment of the former frequencies, channels that were utilized by ABS-CBN and Amcara before. So we just like to make it clear the word before. So to lay down the foundation, frequency slash spectrum is the property of the state. It has never become a property of any private entity. It is only being allowed by the government for use by assignees. That's the word that is being used. So we're just going to lay down the premise and eliminate yung mga misconceptions. And of course, we're happy that we're moving towards total DTV operations. The more operators, then it's going to be better service, broadcast services for the people. So, yun lang. We will be going through several statements given by various entities, and even yung mga statements ng mga Marites ngayon na sa social media na puro spekulasyon, na lagi bigyan, tulungan natin lang silang magkaroon ng konting kalinawan.
Okay, and thank you very much, Sir James, for playing the predicate for all of us. So ano na, so I guess we can start already with the details ng predicate ni Sir James. And I know you guys have been waiting to hear his position on things, of course. And of course, Sir James has always been a technical expert and also a technical expert when it regards to engineering, of course, broadcast engineering. He's a long-time broadcast engineer, so he knows what he is talking about. So, Sir James, ready na tayo? Can we lay the predicate already? So, let's go.
Okay. So, let's first hear, ano ba yung mga narinig nyo? Yung mga ugong-ugong muna tayo sa social media. yung let's pick any of those speculations and then we'll try to shoot them one by one, di ba?
Yun. Una muna, of course, big news ngayon sa big news ngayon over the past week was the announcement from billionaire Gil Kabakungan outscoop everyone in the industry when they reported na the Manny Villar Group AMBS or Advanced Multimedia Broadcasting System, which is owned by Manny Villar, was allotted the frequency of channel 16 and its analog frequency channel 2 na dati alam natin dati from ABS-CBN, and it broke hell on social media, it broke hell on mainstream media as well, dahil apparently billionaire got the scoop before everyone else, getting from their sources inside the NTC. And then later on the NTC confirmed it. And then sumunod pa sila ng pangalawang scoop na kung saan binalita nila na Aliw got the channel 23 and SMNI Swarasub got 43, which we understand are all former frequencies of ABS-CBN as well. And again, Billionario was the one who first reported it. Social media went ballistic. And then later on, the NTC confirmed it. So, ngayon, Sir James, of course, marami ng mga speculation na kesyo daw. Ito basing on the social media comments na kesyo daw, ito raw ay isang midnight, quote-unquote, midnight deal, or kesyo raw may pinaboran, or kesyo raw na dapat nagkaroon daw ng bidding. So, Sir James, pakiklaro nga natin itong isyong ito na ito ng itong frequency allotment na ito. Paano ba 'yung nangyayaring frequency allotment sa mga broadcast net, sa mga broadcast stations?
Before we go there, the question is, tama ba ang ginawa ng NTC? Did they do their job or not in allocating frequencies or channels? My position there is tama si NTC. Now, bakit tama si NTC? Well, NTC is like the steward in terms of allocating the limited spectrum to the users. So there are existing processes in the NTC. So the mere fact that there are a lot of applicants for DTV channels. But due to the scarcity or availability, hindi sila makapagbigay. They cannot allocate. Now, when ABS-CBN had their license expired, so the frequencies or channels that they were using before naturally goes back to the state. And it has been more than a year already that those frequencies are just sitting there. So technically, since there are no more users on those channels, I'm talking of DTV channels 16, which was the assignment of the transitional DTV channel assignment for ABS-CBN then. So it's idle now. There's no occupant. And channel 43, which was used by Amkara Broadcasting, so it's also vacant, so it is now ready for reallocation. Now, when AMBS got the assignment for channel 16, which, as I mentioned earlier, is a transitional channel, which means you have an analog simulcast with digital, so it follows that they should have the same condition, which is a transitional. That's why I am guessing that they were given the channel 2 analog permit also. That's one. Now, why AMBS? Yun yung mga lingering question eh. As I mentioned earlier, meron mga existing processes dyan sa NTC. So, maraming di nakakaalam na ang AMBS ay nakapag-file na ng application for DTV channel, I think since 2006. So, sana hindi ako nagkakamali doon, ha?
Yes, 2006, Sir James, 2006.
Oh, yun. So, nakapag-file na sila noon. At that time, most of the broadcasters and the NTC are in the discussion for digital TV migration of the Philippines. Nasa stage pa yan ng Technical Working Group 1. So, nagkataon na when they filed in that year, nasa una sila sa pila. And we all know that all channels in Metro Manila for use are occupied, di ba? Puno siya eh. So, when they filed during that time, they were number one sa waiting list. So, when the opportunity came and there is spectrum available, then when it comes to the allocation, they will have the first crack to it. So, we're talking of 2006. When did Manny Villar gain corporate control of AMBS? I don't know.
Last, 2021. Last year, Sir James. Kasi AMBS daw was bought by the Villar Group. Actually, ang ginamit na binabili ng mga Villar is Planet Cable. Planet Cable bought AMBS from the original owners, the Vera Group. And according to a report from Rappler, the Vera Group daw had lost around hundreds of millions of pesos sa AMBS because of the pandemic. So
that's 2021.
That's 2021. So ngayon, so, binili na,
so if you
binili...
could, so if you would connect the dots there, even before Manny Villar, wala pa siya, nag-apply na ang AMBS, ang Vera Group. Mm-hmm. Nahandoon na yun. Nakapila na sila. So, mm-hmm, maybe it's a big coincidence lang naman kasi nakapila na yun eh. Mm-hmm. So, do you think they have thought about it? The Villar group have already thought about it in 2006? I don't think so. Mm-hmm. 2006 mm-hmm. to 2021 is
very long time, 15 years. 15 years.
Diba? So it's just a stroke of coincidence that it was them. Having said that, if this had been a different entity, would the people have the same reaction? Diba? Let's just be fair, diba?
Totoo yun. Because, I guess it's just a stroke of coincidence lang siguro, Sir James, na the ones owning AMBS right now is the Villar Group. Coincidental lang. The Villar Group was, of course, the one, nilapitan sila ng Villar Group. I don't know, this is just only a pure speculation na baka Villar Group wanted to enter the broadcasting. Like, for example nga, and report by Big Agustin said na they were applying for a franchise under All Broadcast. There is a bill there in Congress. Pero yun nga, it's languishing there in Congress. So maybe the next best thing is to buy a network na current network and AMBS fit the bill. So I guess hindi naman siguro nag-due diligence ang AMBS na may application to or what. So, nag-due diligence ang Villar Group. So, I guess it's only just a stroke of coincidence lang siguro talaga, Sir James.
Mm-hmm. What do you think, guys? Pat, Jay?
So, ang nasa isip ko, since you mentioned All Broadcast, so, kung in any case na, since granted na tong temporary, this is temporary allocation, pero AMBS already has a license in Congress to install and maintain, di ba?
Yes.
Ayun. If that's the case, doon talaga sila ano, all roads lead to that sa ano, as far as I see it. Pero ang tanong ko ngayon is kung in case na okay na si AMBS tapos si All Broadcast nakatenga pa rin, can they just merge it all together?
Okay. in any corporate changes, transition, takeover sa mga franchise holders, we've learned through the congressional hearing of ABS-CBN's franchise renewal that the concept of just acquiring an existing franchise by buying them out will not work anymore, because there apparently there's a provision that there should be due diligence to Congress whenever a new entity would take over the company that has a broadcast franchise. So, of course, wala naman tayong narinig na nagkaroon ng mga ganoong actions before, ng mga transitions, mga takeovers ng mga franchises. But I guess Congress has changed and decided to implement such a requirement, and Congress has the right to revoke that franchise regardless of the acquisition of a living or a live franchise holder company. So it's not going to be that simple. Now you just need to buy an existing franchise holder. It's not going to work anymore unless you satisfy the requirements of Congress.
So that now in that regards, does AMBS qualify the provisions indicated in their charter or in their license sa Congress?
Do we have a copy of the charter or the requirements? Okay,
actually meron akong nakita. It's actually a resolution. Current resolution. Kasi based on the new franchise law, whenever you're going to buy, I'm not a lawyer, disclaimer lang. But this is what I understand. Whenever an entity buys a franchise, any living franchise, it's stipulated in the franchise act of very recent networks, they are required to report to Congress that they are going to buy the network that has a franchise. And separately, may congressional hearing yan, and issuance, kailangan may approval ng both houses of Congress. Now, I'll just pull up yung concurrent resolution ng AMBS. Wait lang.
Kasi we have RA11253 tapos RA08061, di ba? Ito, dito tayo sa 2019. RA11253, is this the same document that we're referring to?
Is the franchise. Franchise yata yan. Merong House Resolution Advanced Media. Ka lang.
Yeah.
Because ang daming nagtatanong dito
House Concurrent Resolution number 21.
Oh. Sige. Ipila ko lang dito yung RA11253 as you show that.
Okay. Tapos nga pala, no, welcome na natin yung isa nating member, DTV Pilipinas, si Kyle. Kakapasok lang dito sa ating stream.
Sige, yan. Pasok natin. Yan, good evening. Wala ka, Mike. Wala ka, Mike, Kyle. Mike, unmute.
Okay, ma'am. Magandang gabi sa inyong lahat. Ako to si Kyle for Florencio sa DTV Pilipinas din.
Hi, Kyle.
Hello, sir.
Hello, magandang gabi.
Kumusta na Hawaii?
Hawaii?
Eh, outfit mo, parang galing Hawaii eh.
Ayan. Okay, sige, tuloy natin yung usapan.
I think it's best to read the yung contents, yung salient points ng franchise ng AMBS. Nakalista yun doon eh. Yung resolution na binabanggit ni Red kanina is to act as a supplementary requirement for those who have existing franchises. So you have to comply first with the basic requirements of your franchise, the granted franchise, and may extension, which is yung resolution na binabanggit mo, which would act as like an addendum for compliance for all franchise holders. So if we have a copy of the franchise of AMBS, then that would serve as
okay,
good reference.
Okay, ina-upload ko na. Pina-process okay. Na yung franchise. Okay.
I see.
Okay na yan na.
Sige. All right. Zoom natin na konti.
So ayan. Mm-hmm.
Ayun, 112 so, ano nga? This is RA 112 53. We are on the same page.
So ayan.
So this is an act extending for another 25 years the franchise granted to Advanced Media Broadcasting System under RA 8061 to a franchise to construct, install, and operate and maintain radio and television broadcasting stations in the Philippines. So this was in file. This is House Bill 6708.
Balikan lang natin. Yung huling paragraph na binanggit ni Jay, to construct. Can you read again?
Okay. An act extending for another 25 years the franchise granted to Advanced Media Broadcasting System, Inc. under Republic Act No. 8061 entitled An Act Granting the Advanced Media Broadcasting System, Inc. a franchise to construct, install, operate, and maintain radio and television broadcasting stations in the Philippines.
So which means this franchise is a nationwide broadcast franchise. Nationwide yan. Hindi siya limited to certain areas but it covers the whole territory of the Philippines. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, Red.
Ayan. Let's go doon sa section 10. Sale, lease, transfer, grant of usufruct or assignment of franchise.
Okay. The grantee shall not sell, lease, transfer, grant the usufruct of, nor assign this franchise or the rights and privileges acquired thereunder to any person, firm, company, corporation, or other commercial or legal entity, nor merge with any other corporation or entity, nor the controlling interest of the grantee be transferred simultaneously or contemporaneously to any such person, firm, company, corporation, or entity without the prior approval of the Congress of the Philippines.
Yan na nga yung binabanggit ko kanina, di ba? So, medyo mas malakas pa nga yung dating ng mga wordings dito sa ginawa nilang declaration for the franchise of AMBS. And that would be a regular pattern to all franchises that will be granted or renewed to that effect. So, it's not going to be simple. So, it's not about a money game anymore that you're a billionaire and you want to go to broadcast, you just buy some networks. It's not that straightforward purchase anymore. You have to give due diligence to Congress. And Congress will have the last say to say after you have acquired it and they said no, then sorry ka na lang. Ganoon yun. It cannot be transferred. When it is granted to that entity. Now, that entity, when they sell their franchise or their company to another, then the franchise is not automatically transferred. It all depends on the compliance or satisfaction of Congress. I'm not also a lawyer. I'm an engineer by profession. And we're just doing a layman's discussion. We're not taking any position of any government agency or private entity for that matter.
We, every one of us seek answers to this madness. So I believe everything is ano naman, everything fall into place naman, kumbaga. Looking at the profile of Advanced Media Broadcasting System, ito reflected na to sa Wikipedia. Pero it says here na they also own DWKX, which is 103.5. Is this yes, di ba? Yes. Yes, walang mic, Red. Your mic, Red.
Legit yan. Sila talaga okay. May-ari ng 103.5. Now, I have uploaded sa screen natin yung House Concurrent Resolution. So,
okay.
Ito na yung House Concurrent Resolution number 21. Ito na yung nagsasabi na they are allowed to own, the Villars have owned Planet Cable. So, ito na yun. So,
yan,
ito
yun. Okay,
yan. Ayan yun, concurrent resolution okay. number 13. Thank you, thank you. Sige.
So while we're going through the Planet Cable document, can someone check the NTC charter para basahin din natin yung para masubstantiate din naman natin yung pag-allocate ni NTC ng frequency. So we will read the charter later, pero can you just pull it out para ano, and then we go through this document. Sige, Jay, go ahead.
Okay, sorry, NTC Citizens Charter, ano? Tama?
Yes.
Okay, the Citizens Charter. Sige. Let me just look.
BSD, BSD. Broadcast Service
Division. No. The NTC itself. The NTC itself.
We'll go to the main website. Pero sige, can we zoom in? I'll just zoom in, ano? Concurrent Resolution Number 13, Concurrent Resolution approving the sale, transfer, or assignment of the controlling interest in Advanced Media Broadcasting System Inc. to Planet Cable Inc. Malinaw yung sinabi.
And this is 2021, di ba?
Yes.
Uh-huh.
And if we,
okay.
If we, I think let's look back dun sa document na ano natin. May hindi ako nabasa dun na isang part sa RA 11253 on section 10.
Okay, balik tayo sa slide 3.
Kinumpleto ko, hindi ko pa kinumpleto eh. Ang sinasabi di excuse me. Ang sinasabi dito ako natapos eh. Congress shall be informed of any sale, lease, transfer, grant of usufruct or assignment of franchise or the rights and privileges acquired thereunder or of the merger or transfer of the controlling interest of the grantee within 60 days after the completion of the said transaction. Kailan 'to nangyari? So this was on March
30, 2019. Hindi. Ayan. Walang nakalagay na date. Ayun.
Doon sa unang page.
September 15. Hindi, wala nakalagay. Whereas yon is yung date na kung saan kailan sila binigyan ng prangkisa.
Okay, on the last page.
So ito yung concurrent resolution was adopted by the House and the Senate on September
15.
And September 28, 2021. So, yung September 15 is from the House and September 28 sa Senate.
Okay. So, 60 days before that.
And again, a concurrent resolution has the force of a law dahil hindi na kailangan ng pirma ng presidente to. This is not a Republic Act. Again, basic legislation. House resolutions, joint concurrent resolutions do not need any sign or any signature from the president dahil ito ay move ng both houses of Congress, House and Senate.
So it's equivalent to like an executive order, parang ganun.
Yun, parang ganun. It's like an executive order. So hindi na siya kailangan lang kasi is ng isang franchise holder to inform Congress that their franchise is going to be sold. And it doesn't need any approval from the president itself.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Do we have the NTC charter now para lang okay. malinaw?
Sige. I'll just share the NTC charter in a while. Alright.
Kasi there will be... Sige, abangin, inintay natin. Kasi parang na-encounter ko, there'd been some questions regarding the manner on how NTC allocated the channel. I think it has something to do or connection doon sa binanggit mo Red earlier na parang midnight deal, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
So if we go over the NTC charter...
Under then, which division, sir?
No, the whole NTC, the creation of NTC, what is okay. their mandate?
Let's go to the agency profile,
mm-hmm.
if that's the case.
Sige. I think it's there.
Okay. Mandate, yes. I can see the mandate. I'll just need to share the screen mm-hmm. again. Agency profile under the mandate as provided, we can show it na, as provided in Act Number 3846 as amended, Commonwealth Act Number 146 as amended, Executive Law Executive Order Number 546 of 1979. Let me abbreviate this further, no? EO 205 Series of 1987 and RA 7925, which is the Public Telecommunications Policy Act of 1995. The National Telecommunications Commission regulates the installation, operation and maintenance of radio stations both for private and public use, regulates and supervises the provision of public telecommunication services, manages the radio spectrum, and regulates and supervises radio and television broadcast stations, cable antenna television, and pay television systems. So, Sir James, this is the mandate of the NTC.
Yun. So, well covered siya. So, they manage, they supervise, and kinover yung mga types of services that would fall under that category. So, in order to operate, you need the spectrum. And who manages the spectrum? It's the NTC. Yun. So, NTC will get the cue once Congress assigns a franchise to a particular entity and that entity applied. Okay, ito pa pala. As part of the process, hindi porke your franchise holder, it's automatic. No. You still have to apply to the NTC because as the manager, as the steward of this limited spectrum, they have full they have the full management of the spectrum, and they know which are currently in use and which are available for allocation. So they have to sort out through the number of applicants per region or per service area and determine the order of the application. So, ang lagi naman nangyayari kung sino yung nauna, siya yung unang i-accommodate. So, again, it's a big coincidence that AMBN was first in line and they have filed their application in AMBS, sorry, in 2006, and they have waited so long to get a crack at a frequency. So, yun. Now, having said that, it is not only AMBS who got spectrum or channel allocation for digital TV services. Aliw Broadcasting got one too, and Sunshine Media Network Inc. So, pwede tayong mag-move naman further doon or we deal with all AMBS matters first. I think we can move to Aliw Broadcasting and SMNI. And then I just recalled, merong statement ang National Union of Journalists of the Philippines. I think it's pretty interesting to go over their position paper or statement after we've gone through Aliw Broadcasting and SMNI.
Yes, you're
okay,
sure.
So, ihanda natin yung mga ano, yung mga lisensya ng ano as approved and ratified by the Congress.
Basically it's the same lang naman I think the same.
Okay.
Franchises for AMBS has also been the same for Aliw. I think they just renewed
2017
yata.
It takes 25 years, yeah.
Oh, yeah. And yung sa Swarasug sa Sunshine is 2018. Tama ba? 2018. Let me check na. Swarasug.
Swarasug at 17 Congress. 17 Congress. And this is RA 11422 approved by the President on August 22, 2019.
Ay, medyo bago-bago din. So it's basically the same franchises na renewed from Advanced Media. And basically, it's the same. Copy-paste lang naman yung mga franchise eh. Wala namang, hindi naman sila unique to each other eh.
Actually, meron mga changes minsan eh. Kaya hinighlight ko yung binasa ni Jay kanina, yung sa AMBS, na to operate and maintain a TV network in the throughout the Philippines. Nationwide siya. So there are franchises or franchise holders
na local,
no, very specific to a specific region lang yung ino-operate nila. So, yun yung mga
major. Yung mga local, sir. Yung mga local.
Yes. Oh. Kasi, it has something to do with the financial capability. Merong assessment yan. So, if we go through the NUJP statement later, mas maisasubstantiate natin. Pero ang na-establish natin is that when AMBS applied for a DTV channel. It was way back in 2006. It was still under the Vera Group. And it was only last year when the Villar Group acquired AMBS with the permission of Congress. So they have the right to first crack of that spectrum. Now, it would be incredible if the Villar Group have anticipated that these things will happen 15 years ahead, diba? That would be incredible. That's why we use the word big coincidence. If we move to Aliw Broadcasting, if you go over their franchise renewal process, kasi may nabanggit si Red kanina ng midnight deal favoring allies, something like that.
Allies. Hmm. Allies daw of the president. Eh,
if you would check the franchise renewal process of Aliw Broadcasting, I don't think the president signed that franchise. It was approved by default. Oo. Because it was not acted upon by the president, so automatically it becomes approved. The same situation when, anyway, I wouldn't mention that. There are precedents that when pending laws or laws that are pending to the office of the president were not acted upon, by default, it becomes approved. So, correct. If you're an ally, it should have been signed, di ba? It's simple logic. But the franchise renewal of Aliw were passed by default because it was not signed by the president.
Mm-hmm. Pero this is, okay, I have a copy of RA10790 for Aliw Broadcasting extending yung term nila to another 25 years that shall take effect on April 13, 2017. Can we look at the, ano, this is a copy naman, barilin natin tong document na to, ano. Sige, let's show this on the screen. This is the last page. So, 2016. May 3, 2016. Signed ni, ano, President.
It says Noy, Aquino.
President Aquino the Third. So, this is again 10790 Aliw Broadcasting Aliw. Corporation. Yes.
Aliw. 2016. So they're going to expire in 2032. Yan. So yan. So I guess hindi naman siguro issue na yung mga franchise laws na yan are signed by allies or more in ano or minani obra ng mga allies or what. It's a normal
process.
I mean, process lang. Yung nangyari, of course, we understand na naging spotlight lang yung franchise because nga of the ABS-CBN issue.
Yes.
Oh.
Well, the highlight is on AMBS because it's Villar Group. Na-drag lang yung Aliw tsaka yung SMNI. Mm-mm. But we should be happy that the employees of government are doing their jobs, di ba?
Allow me to share na rin yung RA11253 for Swarasug Media Corporation. Let's cue the screen. Tignan nyo. Lapse into law on March 30, 2019 without the signature of the president in accordance with Article 6, Section... Zoom natin na konti. Pampihira nga.
Section 17. 17.
17 or 27?
27, number 1.
One of the Constitution.
The Constitution.
Yeah, walang angal eh. So again, this is RA11253 for Swarasug. Let me just stand corrected. This is Advanced Media Broadcasting System. Walang pirma ni ano presidente oh. Advanced Media Broadcasting System to. Now, let me just go back and pull yung sa Swarasug, okay?
11422.
11422. Ayan. At least tayo binabaril natin yung mga ano dito. Let's see nga kung may pirma. May pirma. May pirma ni Presidente. So, I stand corrected on that.
Mm-mm.
This is 2019 pa. And again, Swarasug Media Corporation of the Philippines.
baka nagkataon lang kasi na of all the Republic Acts, eh, of course, maraming batas na pinipirmahan. Yung lang napirmahan na yung iba hindi napirmahan. So, ano lang, coincidence lang. I mean, marami din naman. I mean, I think GMA's was also signed. GMA's franchise was also signed this year, or last year, 2019 din.
Yes.
Pinirmahan din ni Presidente. Oh, so, wala rin problem din siguro yon. Baka lang kasi yung ibang franchises, eh, naglalabas nito lo kasi hindi nakakalimutan. Ito, may tanong dito yung isa. Ito, Sir James, I think this is controversial to you. Ito, tinatanong nung isa na kung dapat binigay na lang daw sa ibang networks yung 43 kay instead na binigay sa SMNI kasi may dalawang channel na raw sila.
Ayun, no, no, yung dalawang channels.
No, okay, like I mentioned earlier, merong pila kasi dyan, eh. May sequential application. So, first come, first serve, parang ganun eh. So, apparently, SMNI had a pending application. Now, to the question that SMNI has two DTV channels now, I'd like to point out that whatever they're using now is classified as a test broadcast. Remember yung PTV at the time, they were operating channel 48, di ba?
Channel 42.
No, it was 48 first, and then they moved to 42. Mm-hmm. And then when the permanent frequency was determined, yung transitional channel na 14 to 20, exactly yon para doon sa existing VHF operators natin na 2, 4, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, ilalagay sila lahat doon sa 14 to 20. So when 14 to 20 has been finalized to be the permanent channels of those VHF operators who will be operating DTV eventually, so si PTV jumped from 41 or 42 to channel, I think channel 14 ba sila ngayon?
Yes sir, channel 14 actually.
So that would be their permanent frequency or permanent channel. So by following that logic, SMNI, once they utilize the allocation channel 43, they will have to terminate the channel that they're using. Ano ba yung channel yung ginagamit nila ngayon?
40 tsaka ano, 44. May 1390 40. Sila sa ano, yung analog eh.
Let me pull out yung latest spectrum scan natin kanina.
Okay. So yung 39 yung analog nila. So, well, by matter of principle, during the time that we were discussing this in the NTC Technical Working Group, I'm just trying to recall yung mga discussion. Ang meron lang simulcast ng analog and digital ay yung VHF operators. Now, if yung mga nasa UHF, if the frequency is available or there is capacity available for them to use for simulcast, they will be given a channel by the NTC. Or they have the option to migrate straight to digital. So, if you remember, si Zoe had channel 33 analog, but they're not doing 33 simulcast na analog and digital. In fact, they terminated their analog services and went straight to digital, maybe because they have surmised that it would be more economical for them to just terminate the analog services and go to digital na kagad. So for SMNI, eventually they will have to terminate the use of their current DTV and move to the allocation given to them by the NTC.
Mm-hmm.
That's my principle.
Ito, Sir James, kasi before tayo mapunta dun sa issue ng NUGP, naging big issue na bakit para binigay sa AMBS yung channel 2 na VHF. Pakiklaro nga yun, sir, kasi ito ang laking issue nito kasi sabi nga sa DTT circular, no new analog frequencies are going to be given already. Pero bakit daw binigay yung channel 16 at yung channel 2 na VHF na analog na frequency na kasama nung channel 16?
Okay, based on what I know, this is my personal knowledge, and it's not necessarily the position of any government agency, NTC or DICT. As I mentioned earlier, channels 14 to 20 is the transitional simulcast channel for analog and digital. Diba? So before, yes. If you are an operator of the VHF channels 2 up to 13, you are entitled for a transitional simulcast analog and digital channel. And that transitional channel is in channels 14 to 20. So no, when channel 16 was given to AMBS, in order to comply with the concept of simulcast analog and digital, I guess it comes naturally that they should be granted the permit to do the simulcast analog and digital, because that band of frequency, channel 14 to 20, serves that purpose. So it makes sense now, di ba? It makes sense that they have to do that also.
Yeah. Actually,
so in short, kailangan complementary yung lisensya. Hindi lang digital only lang in this case. Pero in sinabi ng NTC na no new analog allocations. Wala namang sinabi na ibibigay yung channel, say, 17. Diba? Tama, Red, no? Kumbaga, that's how I understood the logic. Kung wala naman channel 17 na binigay na VHF or UHF. It's, or tama ba? Kasi ang nakalagay is channel 2 and channel, yung complementary channel, 16. Right?
2 and 16.
Okay. Ayun.
Kasi, of course, ang naging issue kasi dyan, bakit daw pa daw binibigay yung channel 2? Bakit total na naman daw mag-digital transition na raw? Pero, again, the digital transition is a very complicated thing to discuss as well. Very complicated. Masalimuot din yan. So, yun nga.
The criteria kasi to be an occupant of any channels in 14 to 20 is that you have to simulcast it. So I think it is just following what existing conditions or criteria for you to be there.
More on technicality lang talaga sila.
In order to comply. Otherwise, hindi siya ilalagay sa 16. Notice, when channel 43 was given to SMNI, they were not given any analog channel. Diba?
Digital. And now, this leads to the commentary in social media. Ayan, ito yung eligibility. Ito, I think this is zero. Ito yung digital TV memo, di ba?
Yes, this is the eligibility. Yeah, this is the memorandum circular.
IIR
02-2018. So, okay. Yan, nakalagay yung eligibility.
All operating and duly authorized Mega Manila VHF television networks are each entitled to a channel assignment from channels 14 to 20, provided that they file their manifestation to convert their analog television service to digital terrestrial broadcasting, television broadcasting as required under MC number 07-12-2014, and they undergo drawing of lots based on sequence of choice to determine their channel assignment under section 4.3.1. Ano yung drawing of lots though?
Yun yung parang bubunot ata sila ng bubunot sila kung anong channel ang makukuha nila. That's what I know.
Ruleta na lang ganun. Bingo.
The concept of drawing of lots kasi is para maiwasan yung bakit si X station binigay sa kanya si channel 14? O bakit si Y station binigay sa kanya yung 15? Or si Z station, ba't ako nilagay sa 20? So, para walang issue, so nag-draw lots sila. And kung ano yung mabunot mo, that would be the allocation of your network.
Is it para walang cherry picking ba?
Is it safe to assume na nag-meeting, ano, mini-meeting itong tatlong ito ni NTC or dalawa or ano, tapos nag-drawlat sila doon o sa inyo ito, tapos sa inyo. Ganun ba yon? Is it safe
silang,
to assume?
Silang pito ang nag-draw ng lots. Oh, ang nag-draw dyan is si ABS-CBN, si PTV, si TV5, si GMA, RPN, ZOE, and IBC-13.
Okay, so since given that, tapos na yung ruleta, done na talaga to beforehand, and then we come to the present day, since wala na nga si ABS, so kung saan yung kulang, doon na lang ibinigay yung, ano, yung natitirang, kumbaga yung frequency na bakante ni ABS?
Yes.
Wala ang toilets, no?
So kasi itong binasa natin, yan naka-highlight, before even the drawing of lots, di ba, they are entitled, nakalagay eh. Mm-hmm. The NCR channels are entitled for a transitional channel. So when AMBS assumed that channel 16 position with all the entitlement mentioned, then nag-carry over yung analog channel.
Let's read sa 3.2 para may interesting na ano doon. Eh. Barilin lang natin yung clause na yon sa 3.2 because what we read is 3.1. Oo.
Yun yung sandali lang ako, mag-CR break lang ko.
Sige. Ayan, pero before that, sige, let's habang nagbe-break si Sir James, let's take a break na rin. Anong mga comments natin? Highlight natin.
Mamaya, no? May mga maraming mga tanong dito eh. Maraming interesting na tanong.
Hindi ko pa tinitingnan yung comment section. Maraming siguro tanong.
Marami na mga interesting na tanong dito, pero of course mamaya sasagutin natin 'yan. Pero to round up
lang muna tayo.
I-round up lang muna natin yung kaninang sinabi ni Sir James. Again, what Sir James said is tama yung ginawa ng NTC. And the allocation given to AMBS is what he calls big coincidence. Yun yun, big coincidence. That is words, ha? That is words. Big coincidence lang yun. Kasi as we pulled up all the franchises, nung details ng franchises ng both ng AMBS, and yung ano nga, yung kanilang house concurrent resolution na eh, nagkataon lang talaga na the Villar Group bought the network. And like I said nga, I quoted an article from Rapper, sabi nga nila na the network was losing money because of the pandemic. And we all understand that. I mean, yung 103.5K light has been what? Mishmash ng mga kanta noong time na bago sila nag-pandemic, and they're not even rating high on the radio dial. I mean, mas kilala pa yung station na yung Magic 89.9 on yung mga pamanga
FM2
stations ng
FM2 ng PBS, yun. Di ba?
De. Magic. Yung mga Magic, okay. Station ng Vera, ha? Stations ng Vera, ha? Yung Tiger 22.
Tiger 22. Now it makes sense. Kasi pag sinabi mong Vera, hindi ko mag-guess yan. Pag sinabi mong Tiger 22, 99.5.
Yan. Mas sikat kasi yung, of course, their flagship is Magic, 89.9. Mm-hmm. And of course, yung iba pa mga stations nila, 99.5 RT, Play FM. So yun. Jam, 88.3 pala. Yan. So Sir James, yes, going jam. Back, yung tungkol doon sa 3.2?
Anong content sa 3.2?
Sige, babasahin natin.
Basa.
Ay. Basa. 3.2. Nawala.
Ayan.
Ayan. Sige, 3.2. If any of the Mega Manila VHF networks is not interested with its entitlement mentioned in 3.1, thereby resulting in unassigned channels in channels 14 to 20, after drawing of lots based on sequence of choice among those interested, the commission shall consider all operating and duly authorized Mega Manila UHF TV networks that have filed the requisite manifestation to convert their analog television service to DTTV as required under Memorandum Circular Number 07-12-2014. So anong ano, yun, meron pa bang susunod dito sa eligibility?
There should be. Meron pa yan.
Meron to, meron. Let's see.
All right.
3.3.
It should can't there be available channels after 3.1 and 3.3? Ito yung sagot natin eh. The commission shall consider entities with pending petitions for the issuance of authorization to provide DTTV service in Mega Manila and with no existing analog VHF or UHF TV operations in the area. Dito tayo magkakatalo sa 3.3. Kasi, okay, Tagalogin natin ha. Kung may available channels pagkatapos ng section 3.1 at 3.2, ang commission ay titingin na sa mga entities na may pending na petition para sa issuance ng authorization para mag-provide na ng DTTV service sa Mega Manila at and with no existing analog of it. Ito gusto kong intindihin tong last phrase na to eh. Yung end with no existing analog VHF or UHF TV operations in the area. How do we interpret this?
Hindi there is, one, there is one simple statement there.
Yes, sir.
That statement represents new players.
New okay. players.
Because, di ba, they have no existing service, diba?
VHF or UHF. Mm. Again, Sir James, you're telling about new television players.
New applicant. When I say new players, new applicant to.
So I wouldn't want to... radio?
No, because we're talking of digital TV, diba?
Okay.
So naturally, they are new players, new TV operator.
New TV
so, like what I've said earlier, actually, na-cover na rin dito sa nakasulat lahat dito yung binanggit ko, when spectrum is available. Yung 3.1 is the privilege extended to the VHF channels to have the first crack of the channels 14 to 20. If you're not interested, as mentioned in 3.2 na yata yun, then the commission will reallocate it to someone. And then, I think, na-mention na ulit dyan sa 3.3, for the applicants, yung mga existing, sa mga applicant in general, they would be entertained when spectrum is available. Unahin muna yung existing. And then once na accommodate lahat ng existing, i-open siya sa new players when spectrum is available. Now, ang question is, lahat ba ng existing na-accommodate? Of course, yes, because they have existing allocations in analog sa UHF. All they have to do is terminate the analog and go to digital. They still have the allocation.
And this is the case with the Zoe Broadcasting Network, am I correct?
Zoe is an example. It's a good example yung ginawa ni Zoe. Why wait for a DTV allocation when you have your own frequency na and just terminate analog and go to digital straight, diba?
Iyon. So I guess that's very clear na, no? Very klaro na yung process ng pag-allocate ng frequency, sir, di ba? So I guess we have touched already how frequencies are allocated, how applications are granted, and of course yung proseso kung paano ni-reallocate yung frequency. Pero of course, pumasok na naman yung issue. Of course, dahil nga itong mga frequencies ito ay owned by ABS-CBN.
No, they were not owned by ABS-CBN. The state granted the use.
They were.
So para maiwasan kasi yung misunderstanding ng karamihan na those channels are owned by ABS-CBN. No, ABS-CBN was licensed to use those frequencies by the state. And the frequencies ownership resides with the state.
Okay, so klaro yon. ABS-CBN does not own the frequencies.
They were allocated.
They were given allocated. The license to operate. They allocated. The license to operate. Yeah.
Yeah, technically nobody owns any frequency kasi natural resource yan eh. Right?
Oo. Kasi yun din, lumalabas sa social media na ABS-CBN owns daw these frequencies. Lalo sa
so at least nabaril natin, yung mga maling sinasabi sa social media. In fact, even GMA doesn't own the frequency they're using now. The same with TV5, Zoe, and to the rest. They were given the privilege by the state to utilize that frequency as governed with by existing laws. As managed and regulated by the NTC.
Okay, simplehan natin. Sa every sign of sequence, every, diba, for example, this is GMA Network. We are a commercial broadcast station located in Diliman with NTC license to operate under BSD X kung anong year.
2022, kunyari.
Oo, gano'n. BSD 0000-2022. Meron pa nga doon, di ba, yung REN to operate from this state to this state, di ba?
Renewal.
Di ba, authorizing the station to operate from this date to that date.
Yeah.
Then, authorizing the station to operate from, kunyari, January 31, 2025, gano'n.
Oo. And iba pa yun sa congressional license nila, 'di ba?
Iba pa yun
sa congressional franchise, iba so, pa yun sa franchise.
Hiwalay.
Ang hirap maging broadcaster.
Hindi.
Mahirap. Marami kang babayaran.
Yun.
Marami kang juice.
Like we said nga already before, a grant of a franchise does not preclude you from owning a network outright. Yes, you have the franchise. Pero yung meron ka mismong frequency, wala. It doesn't automatically give you the allowance or it doesn't give you automatically the right of a frequency.
The franchise establishes that your entity can avail of the introduction of broadcast services. Union. But then, now that you have the franchise, in order to avail of the free-to-air services, you have to seek permission. You have to undergo a quasi-judicial process in the NTC to determine your technical and financial capability. And then once approved, there will be a final determination of available spectrum for allocation. If there is none, after going through the quasi-judicial proceeding, and there is no available frequency, you will be put in the waiting list. And that waiting list will have an order.
Ayun.
So, yun yung mga steps.
What would be the order?
First come, first serve.
First come, first serve. So, tagalogin natin, just to summarize it up. Hindi porket may lisensya ka na to operate galing sa Kongreso, ay pwede ka na mag-broadcast sa frequency. Kailangan may permiso ka para ikay makapag-broadcast sa frequency na yon. May permiso ka na mag-broadcast and may frequency ka para mag-broadcast on that frequency. Tama?
Kailangan pahintulutan ka ng NTC gumamit ng isang channel allocation mo or yung band of frequency.
Mm-mm.
At pag wala yun, maghihintay ka.
Mm-mm. Correct.
Mm-mm. Correct, sa kaso correct. Naman sa ibang bansa tayo tumingin. Sa kaso ng UK, bakit may mga pirate radio stations? So iba din yung sistema ng batas nila doon, iba yung sistema ng allocation nila, but the state owns the frequency.
Sa atin din naman maraming pirate channel maraming pirate na FM.
Yes. Pero at the end of the day, ang frequency na kahit na mag-pirate ka diyan, ang frequency mo ay hawak ng estado under the constitution.
Mm-hmm.
Ang naalala ko sa 1987 Constitution, the state shall control the land, the air, and the seas. So, what does that mean? No. Diba? Included
the government din yung owns, ano? I mean, the state owns it. I mean, wala. Yeah. It's very elemental Constitution. Elemental Constitution.
Basic aralin panglipunan to.
Yeah. Basic constitutional law. Constitution. Mm-hmm. And sa college, I mean, we all know the state owns natural resources. Sabihin natin natural resources as a whole.
Mm-hmm.
Natural resources. Kaya nga even telephone companies apply for a franchise. mining companies apply for a franchise, 'di ba? Dami eh. Kasi nga very ano eh. Kasi nga,
why do we have a franchise ba? Why do we have a franchise?
Regulation.
Regulation. It has to be regulated. Why? If the industry will have serious impact to the lives of the Filipino and to the country as a whole, you need to get a congressional franchise. For example, water.
Maynilad and Manila Water.
Papayag ba kayo na hindi dumaan sa scrutiny ang isang kumpanya na magkocontrol ng tubig na iinumin, gagamitin ng mga tao? E paano kung nasira ulo ng isang kumpanyang yon? Pinatay lahat ng tubig. So that's why they have to go through that scrutiny of obtaining a franchise. The same with power, mining. What else? Isipin nyo, if telecoms, a particular industry has serious impact on the lives of the people, you would need a franchise. Now, iba yung franchise ng mga tusok-tusok na mga peaceful dyan. That's totally different. That's why we like, we'd like to use the word congressional franchise.
And now we lead into the hot topic discussion na ng sinasabi ng National Union of Journalists of Philippines na ito raw na pagbigay ng franchise na ito or pagbigay ng mga allocations na ito, spectrum na ito sa mga players na they accuse that are allies ng presidente, eh, number one, violates press freedom, and number two, could severely limit the information dissemination activities and could possibly limit daw the capability of the public to be informed. Separately, Danilo Araw of the UP College of Mass Communications suggested na dapat daw ang NTC daw should have independent panel members. Dapat daw hindi raw siya ina-appoint ng presidente. So, sir, ano na natin to?
Madali ang ano dyan eh. Ano yung nasusulat dun sa header ng every document na, na may NTC? What does it say? Republic of the Philippines. Di ba? Office of the President. Tama? Let's see the NTC documents.
That was the old NTC, DICT
na siya. Attached
Under DICT na yan. Yeah.
Okay.
Attached agency na siya.
That's still under ano, kasi naka tama, Republic of the Philippines National Telecommunications Commission. Before kasi under OP talaga yan, ano. Tapos yung powers turned over sa DICT, tama? Okay, so at least nabaril na natin yun.
No. Until now, NTC is still now under the Office of the President, but under they are DICT, classified as an attached agency of the DICT, but they still report to the Office of the President.
Ayun. So nabaril na natin kaya nga, yung ano yun.
Kaya nga, ang council ng NTC is not the Council of the DICT, but the Office of the Solicitor General, OSG.
And this is why makoconnect natin yung dots between, 'di ba, yung panahon nung naano pa yung front, yung ano nag pina-shutdown talaga yung sa ABS which is under OSG yata yung
OSG.
Yun yung lawyer ng government agency.
I think to clarify, it was Congress who denied the franchise renewal.
Kuwaranto yun.
And while that process is ongoing, there was a separate motion being done by the Solicitor General. It was being done in parallel. Because at that time, by my recollection, expired na yung franchise ni ABS, di ba?
Pa-expire na.
I think ang pinag-uusapan noon is to allow for the NTC to allow the continued operation of ABS-CBN while the franchise renewal is pending with Congress. Yun yung in-object ng Office of the Solicitor General. Tama ba? Pare-pares ba tayong recollection?
Yeah, I think yung yeah,
Siya yung nag-warn, siya yung nag-caution sa NTC na do not do that.
Do not do that. And also, sila din yung nag-raise nung tungkol doon sa controversial na pay-per-view.
No, it's pay-per-view. That's Congress. Congress din nag-deliberate noon. Although may partial mention si Solicitor General doon, but it was discussed thoroughly in the hearing sa Congress.
Ayun. Pero yun nga, Sir James, ito klaruhin natin to. Kasi of course sinasabi ng mga media groups violation dot of press freedom yung pagbigay ng franchise sa ng pagbigay ng allocation sa the accuser of
who said that
allies NUJP.
Ayan, ito.
Okay, so we were able to establish already that AMBS is a stroke of luck. Aliw or SMNI, their franchise renewal was never signed by the president, so they were extended by default. So if you're an ally, you don't get to that point of default. It is going to be signed, di ba?
Correct.
So that's number one. So regarding freedom of something again?
Oh, freedom of expression. Ito yung statement.
Freedom of expression.
NUGT.
Okay. Sige. So let's read per paragraph, and we'll try to shoot them down one by one. Who would read first paragraph? I cannot read again.
As allies, ito, statement as former frequencies assigned to Duterte allies, our call remains Laban Kapamilya. And to quote, as allies of ABS-CBN's media workers in the campaign to keep the network on the air, the National Union of Journalists of the Philippines is concerned over the assignment of its former frequencies to Villarlink Advanced Media Broadcasting System, Inc. According to reports, it is unclear how the National Telecommunications Commission checked Advanced Media's capability to operate a TV network and the traditional public selection process, to quote, was not conducted.
Ayan, sir, that's the first paragraph pa lang yan?
That's first the first two paragraphs.
Sir, okay. Ito, sige, let's shoot that. Kasi it was mentioned there, parang kino-question yung capability of the NTC or if they have done proper due diligence in determining the capability of AMBS to construct, maintain, and operate a TV network. Is that the wording?
Yes. Parang ganun. Parang ganun. Somehow. Sir. Parang kine-question nila na bakit daw hindi nagkaroon ng selection process sa pagbid ng prangkisa.
Okay, kasi mali. I would say outright mali. They should have done proper research considering their journalist. Why? Because NTC conducts a quasi-judicial process in determining the technical and financial capability of any applicant. I know this because I appear in those hearing when I prepare technical feasibility study for an entity. So in that design, it will undergo strict scrutiny. The what is the scrutiny I'm mentioning? When an applicant applies to the NTC, that application will be cascaded to all parties concerned. It will be circulated by the NTC, and all of those parties have the opportunity to shoot the design itself and question whatever they want to raise during the hearing. So they have the right to object the granting of a channel or frequency to this applicant based on technical merit. After that technical hearing, there would be a financial determination of the capability, which will be subject to the same process. You will have oppositors who will challenge every bit of information that you have submitted to the NTC. So it's an open document. Now, if you have something to say to oppose about an application, then you should have joined that quasi-judicial proceeding. Ganon lang kasimple yon. How now, when AMBS got this channel allocation, well, because they were first in line, but of course, they have gone through the quasi-judicial process and they were able to hurdle the technical and financial questions. So, mali yung opinion ng NUJP dyan to question the processes of the NTC. In fact, this process has been in place for so long in force. Now, nabanggit pa dyan to operate a TV network. Mali ulit. Definitely mali. Now, bakit ko sinasabing mali? AMBS was given a channel allocation for NCR only. Is that a network?
No, it's a TV station.
It's a station in NCR. It is not a network.
Kasi kung network yan, kuha na din ba ang frequencies ng allocations pati sa probinsya, Sir James?
Oh, hindi naman siya carried over na lahat ng frequencies na ino-operate before ni ABS-CBN, itin-transfer lahat kay AMBS. Hindi.
Mm-hmm. And sir, diba? Question lang.
Saka ang pangit, yes. may mali siya kasi ang dating eh. They should refer to AMBS. That's the franchise holder. It's unfair naman to use the word Villar Group because the mere use of the word Villar Group, you are insinuating political influence. That's not fair, di ba? Let's just be fair. In fact, media itself should be in between the pros and the cons, the yes and the no.
They should be the fourth estate.
You should be reporting the facts and not bringing editorial or color to whatever statement. Mm-hmm. If we would ito continue, sige. Go ahead.
Ito Sir James, ha? Iklaro natin ito. Isa pa yung inaccuse nila. Ito, inaccuse nila to, ha? As, quote-unquote, regulatory processes can be used against perceived critics, they can also be used to favor allies like the powerful, quote-unquote, powerful Villar family, which has a member in the legislative branch and until last year, one in the president's cabinet. Cargado.
Okay, so that's Camille Villar and Mark Villar. Tama. Okay.
And Senator. Yes.
Okay, Senator Cynthia Villar pala. I have a question. Ano yung quasi-judicial? Yun.
Ano?
Linawin lang natin.
Comelec. Comelec.
Ang quasi-judicial, pag sinabing quasi, it looks like or sounds like or almost similar to a legal court proceeding.
Okay.
Proceeding.
Similar to a court proceeding.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so tinatanggap naman yan. There are several entities that has the power of quasi-judicial hearing and NTC is Comelec. One of them.
Comelec.
Comelec. Okay.
Ayun, kasi maririnig natin yung quasi-judicial, of course, there will be people who will be asking that. So, thank you for the clarification. We proceed back to the Villars. Ito nga, they're mentioning the Villars here. Not directly by name, but the full family. So, what will be the approach to this?
That is uncalled for. That's unfair. Let's not use the characters. Let's use the juridical entity, which is AMBS, which means any corporation is like a person. They have their own life. So that's AMBS. It's just so happened that it's owned by the Villars now or controlled by the Villars. Okay. Meron bang ano ba yung tawag doon yung you can see the future?
Foresight.
Kasi how can they have anticipated in 2006 that ABS-CBN would have their franchise expired and not renewed and they could jump in and get that frequency allocation? So mali yung assumption kagad eh, because when AMBS applied for a DTV channel, it was way back in 2006. And they have gone through the usual quasi-judicial proceedings. It just so happened that in 2021, the Villar Group acquired their network. Now, have the Villar Group been aware of AMBS being first in line? I don't think so. Kaya nga, di ba, ginamit natin word kanina, it's a big coincidence lang. because it's not only AMBS who has a pending application sa NTC.
Mm-hmm.
They could have purchased Aliw, di ba? Nagkataon lang that the Vera Group or AMBS is ready to sell at that time, and they might have approached the Villars, di ba? We don't know the circumstances on the sale.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what possibly we know yun. Is that possibly this is purely a commercial transaction between two entities. Now, everything mm-hmm. else is just a stroke of luck.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So, yun. Ito pa, dinagdag pa nila dito. Other frequencies previously used by ABS-CBN have been assigned to Aliw and Sunshine. These networks are perceived to be friendly to government.
We've already established that their franchise renewals were approved by default. It was not signed by the president.
And Aliw, DWIC, you know, DWIZ. At saka yes. CNN Philippines. Ano, by extension, CNN Philippines, right, Aliw?
Mm-hmm, yeah, correct.
CNN. Oh.
Under Noel Cabangon ba?
Antonio Cabangon. Edward.
Sorry. So, Noel Cabangon is the guitarist.
Sorry.
Ayan, Antonio Cabangon Chua, ambassador. Okay. Ambassador.
The ALC Group.
So, ayun.
Ang tawag na nga nila dito is Aliw Media Group. Together with CNN Philippines, Mr. Smira and DWIZ. At saka yung Philippines Graphic.
Pero yeah.
Okay.
Ayun. Yun. Perceived to be friendly daw to the government. And
okay, that's speculation. That paragraph is purely speculative. So again, as a media practitioner, you are not supposed to be speculating. You're supposed to be stating facts only.
Mm-hmm.
Sige, question. Okay, sige. Ito. Let's list down yung ilang mga programs ng DWIZ and SMNI. Kasi yung pinupunto nila na perceived to be friendly to government. So, first and foremost, SMNI. What shows are on SMNI? Yung kung mga news programs sila, mga commentary programs sila, and then they have allotted some time for Bongo?
Hindi. Parang gano'n. Wala. No. Tama? No.
What would be it?
Ang shows ng SMNI, of course, religious programs ni Tiboloy.
Yes.
And then, news programs. And of course, yung mga commentary shows nila.
Si Mike Abe, diba?
Mike Abe, Lorraine Badoy, and Ka Eric. Mm-hmm. Thinking Pinoy, RJ Nieto.
Yes.
Sastrogando Sasot.
Yes.
Mike Defensor. Mike Defensor.
Si TK.
Yun. Mike Defensor. Yun. Si Point of Order.
Yun lang yung mga shows nila. Okay, sige. How about sa DWIZ, yung Karambola? So, sino yung mga hosts noon?
That's only one show.
Ilang pang
show? Karambola. Attorney Trixie Angeles, Conrad Banal, who is a very objective journalist, Jonathan De La Cruz, and special and on sometimes Attorney Larry Gadon. Oh.
Mm-hmm. Ayun.
Nandun
okay.
pa sina Vic De Leon Lima, andun pa sina David Oro, Alex Calda. Edwin Eusebio.
So in short,
si Deo Makalma ba sa DWIZ ba? Si Deo Makalma.
Sorry.
Okay. So how do we perceive na itong mga kasi wala tayong makita ano eh. If these are friendly, perceived to be friendly to the government, bakit walang program ang government of the Philippines or either the prolific personalities under the government, Bongo. Does Bongo have a program on IZ and SMNI?
Wala.
Okay.
Wala.
Sino pa ba? Kasi pinipinpoint natin eh. Again, barilan to ng statements.
Hindi, kasi the NUGP is insinuating that these programs or the shows of these programs are, quote-unquote, they thought, friendly. Friendly. Mm-hmm. Dawa friendly or biased.
Mm-mm.
Which is wrong
to insinuate. Eh.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Pero hindi ba nila, every before broadcast, sinasabi naman nila, the views and opinions of this program are
just not reflect.
Ayun, diba? Yun yung legal clause eh. Does not reflect the station, does not reflect the management, does not reflect the network. Even Boyabunda uses that.
Oh, di ba?
Ayun. We wouldn't even know if they are block timers actually.
Ayun. Actually, yes. Kasi hindi yun nababanggit kung block timer ka eh. Unless you're really a block timer like A to Z, which is lantaran na block timer ng ABS.
Right? Meron din kasi sa radyo kasi na program block timer. Sa probinsya yun. Marami sa probinsya yun.
Yung mga gamot, di ba? Yung mga food supplements?
Yeah, pero hindi. Sa mga probinsya, may mga local journalists. Local journalists. And I guess, the NUJP knows this.
Yeah. Let's finish all the statements of NUJP muna. We're through with the third article na ba? I mean, third paragraph.
Fourth paragraph.
Fourth article.
Other frequencies previously used by ABS-CBN. Ito na yun, ano? O sige. Last paragraph, we are concerned at the concentration of power in a corporate media landscape already dominated by conglomerates and political clans. Nawala. This has dire implications on the people's right to relevant information, especially during times of crisis. Now, let me just say something here. Ano? Nung nawala ang ABS-CBN, aminado tayo, nawala yung parang bridges to communication kasi ABS-CBN halos yung may foothold talaga sa mga probinsya. Halos,
they have the largest deployment kasi.
Yes. Kaya sa Cagayan, di ba, yung sa ano, we can say na ano, yes, pero what would be the ano, that's my thought. But you can shoot me right here now.
So, kasi ano ba yung, ano, sinasabi ka, yun nga, para namang unfair naman sa ibang media companies.
Mm-mm.
That's very much unfair naman. Eh yun nga, they're saying na corporate media landscape already dominated by conglomerates and political clans.
That's a sweeping statement kasi. That's a sweeping statement. You have to be very specific.
Mm-hmm. And again, pop quiz. What is ABS-CBN?
A conglomerate, part of a conglomerate.
See? Get my drift.
Lopez Inc. got majority drift of the shares sa ABS. So, okay, I don't get it. Ang GMA is owned by the Gozons and the Duavits. Duavits.
And the Jimenez. Gozon, Jimenez, Duavit.
Duavit.
Yeah. So, ito yung Berit. Ito yung rate, yun.
Oo. And let's not talk about RPN or CNN Philippines because it's a state na, ano eh, kumbaga para may share din ng government yan, di ba? Through PCPASA.
Lumayo ka pa. TV5
is PLDT ko, ano, trust fund. Oh.
Di ba? Parang ang mali naman ang statement ng NUJP. They're saying na concern sa concentration of power, pero most of their members are actually working in corporate media.
Yun nga eh. Even okay, let's say yung dati kong in-internan Manila, ano, the Standard FMR, pwede tayo ano eh, we can say that eh, pero yun nga, again, ito, this also applies to ABS-CBN altogether because it's part of a conglomerate, TV5 too.
Ay, kapim, di ba? Conglomerate din yan eh.
Yung?
Yeah. Beam.
Beam is ano, Globe Trust Fund, di ba?
Pero yun nga,
Globe Retirement Fund.
Yun.
Oo. Pero again, so, like I
that's
said.
That's why I mentioned in almost all of the paragraphs given, stated by NUJP, we have established that it is not based on facts, it is speculative, it contains a lot of sweeping statements, and it is unfair to the parties who have been given the channels by the NTC despite their legal compliance to all the requirements. So I guess if we would vote, if the NUJP statement is right or wrong, I would say 80% of it is wrong.
Let's
paragraph eh.
Okay, go ahead.
NUJP recognizes that new networks could mean new jobs for media workers, but we hope that the assignment of its former frequencies will not be another hindrance to getting ABS-CBN back on air and laid off colleagues back at their jobs. We hope as well that the entry of new TV networks will mean more sources of information and reliable news instead of content catered to serve its owners' political and business interests. Okay, we finished the whole statement of the NUJP. What else should we discuss about these
paragraphs? Ito pa lang eh. Sinasabi nila, there should not be any hindrance. There should not be any hindrance daw on getting ABS-CBN back on the air.
What is A to Z?
Okay. Pag-usapan natin yon. No hindrance. Are they saying that the frequencies used by ABS-CBN before should be reserved until they return? My answer is no, because their franchise have expired and there are pending applicants in the line. When ABS-CBN secures a franchise, in effect, they are a new player because it's a new franchise. It is not a renewal. They would have to apply for a new franchise. Okay, so being a new franchise, technically they are a new player, so they have to get in line in terms of allocation. Now, the word, there should be no hindrance. I don't think there's a hindrance for them to return to air. But again, they have to undergo the usual processes of the first Congress for the franchise, and then the quasi-judicial proceeding of the NTC, and then wait for available spectrum.
Mm-hmm.
Yun yung process. Tama naman yun, di ba?
Yeah. Not, I could understand, if I could put it that way, yes. That is the understanding. Pero ito, Sir James, one day ago, meron na interview na isang taga democracy.net.ph si Pierre Gala. He said na kung mag-apply daw ang ABS-CBN, dapat daw or pwede naman daw sila mag-apply for Channel 10. For Channel 10, VHF Channel 10. So, sir, your thoughts
VHF?
About it kasi oo, Channel
yes,
10
daw. VHF daw.
Channel 10.
Let me pull up that one.
Did he lay down any basis, technical in nature and regulatory, to say that Channel 10 is available? Because if it were so, that channel would have not been classified as a taboo channel for the longest time. The same with Channel 12 and the same with Channel 8. There should be a technical basis on that one. And that technical basis will have to undergo the scrutiny of the quasi-judicial proceeding for the technical feasibility study. So imagine, I'm a regular sa NTC when it comes to preparing this kind of technical studies. Imagine that you are going against all possible oppositors from all networks because all the networks are informed. So you have to rebut all the questions that they have. They have great engineers who would advise their lawyers. You attack this portion of the design. Wala pa naman akong client na na-deny. All of them are approved. Because they hired the right person, di ba? So that's the kind of scrutiny that I'm trying to explain. Now, when you go to the financial scrutiny, hindi na ako yon. There should be a certified public accountant. And that accountant will have to be on his toes or her toes on the challenges by the other accountants from the opposing parties. So it's not that easy. That's why we should respect NTC's processes on this one.
Ito, may nagko-comment dito. Bakit daw yung ibang frequency na nasa analog ang nag-shut off? Why the billiard led not see this opportunity? Bakit ngayon lang?
Nasagot na kanina yan,
ah. Nasagot niya ata kanina to.
Merong question dito yung EMA kay Joey Josh.
Ayan, si Joey Josh. Okay.
Sabi niya, they can be a new player in the future if they apply a new franchise. But what happens was actually politically motivated, which is very unfair to ABS-CBN. I think that's what NUJP is trying to say. I'd like to know what is politically motivated first para mapag-usapan nating mabuti. Ako, I have a lot of friends and colleagues sa ABS-CBN. In fact, relative who lost their job. But my thinking is that those people who have lost their job in the broadcasting industry will have the opportunity because the operations that they have vacated, somebody, a new entity will operate, diba? And they would need people, competent people who knows broadcast. So it's just a matter of moving to that new entity and to be able to practice their specific skill sets and profession. So may dinugtong si Joey Josh. Until now, puro naman po hearsay kasi ang mga paratang. Maniniwala siguro ako na ABS-CBN doesn't deserve the renewal if all allegations were proven in the court. Well, ang opinion ko kasi dito is that the powers on matters of renewal of franchise is with Congress. And at that time, when ABS-CBN's franchise was expired, they went through a renewal process, di ba? Yung hearing nila. And they were scrutinized by Congress. So at the end nung processes nila sa Congress, they voted. Now, I myself, I cannot question the process of Congress on how they did this because it's within their power. So NTC will just have to wait for the franchise renewal or grant before they could act upon the issuances of licenses. Now, if it's politically motivated or cases should have been filed in court, I agree with that aspect also, but that is outside of Congress. The hearing they've done in Congress is for the renewal of the congressional franchise. If they deemed it justifiable or otherwise, it's up to Congress. Now, when it comes to criminal aspect, then that would have to go through the courts. And the ones that will go to the court would be the allegations thrown against ABS-CBN. I have to admit that there were a lot of flagrant mistakes on the allegations of Congress towards ABS-CBN. Now, what's most shocking to me is that the legal team of ABS-CBN was not able to rebut very simple, I guess, not very simple, but more of the technical domain, the domain of the engineers who can easily rebut the allegations towards ABS-CBN. I will not elaborate further on this one because when I was hearing those accusations from the congressman towards ABS-CBN, I was literally jumping on my seat that it was easy to rebut all of those accusations but were never rebutted by the legal team of ABS-CBN. And I can still hear the same allegations towards ABS-CBN as a pending question that remains to be answered by the same congressman. Now, if I had been an employee of ABS-CBN, it would take great pride and joy for me to rebut all of those allegations. I will not discuss that here. But again, I have friends, colleagues, and relatives who work for ABS-CBN who lost their jobs. And I just hope that they would find or they would be able to get back to the workforce again.
Klaro yon, Sir James. Klaro yon. So okay. Meron pa ba mga ibang questions dito?
Actually, let's look at the other questions. Ano? Sige. May mga ano dito? May mga na mention dito. Eh. Titingnan natin na kung so let's see.
Ito, bakit daw hindi ginagamit yung ano daw, yung 3, 6, 8, 10, 12 na VHF? I think we have already mentioned this earlier.
Na-mention na yan kanina.
Uh-oh. Sagutin mo, Pat.
Yeah. Ito na. Let's pull this up. Yan. 3, 6, 8, 10, and 12. Kasi ginagamit lang yan for guard band. Para hindi magkaroon ng co-channel interference. Yan na yung sagot.
Co-channel interference, which means?
For example, if you have
co-channel, adjacent channel.
Adjacent channel interference. Adjacent channel. What does that mean? Layman's terms.
When you say co-channel interference, you are using the same frequency or channel. When you say adjacent, for example, an active channel, channel 9, the adjacent channel would be channel 8 and channel 10. So there would be adjacent channel interference if you put analog to another service side by side.
Paano yung channel 4 and 5?
There's a gap na 4 megahertz in between. Eh. May gap doon. So, si ABS-CBN is on channel 54 to 60, that's channel 2. And then channel 3 is 60 to 66. And then channel 4 is 66 to 72. And then 72, may 4 megahertz gap, and then channel 5 na. So, 76 to 82 si channel 5. And then si channel 6 ay, ano ba yung FM. Nabanggit ulit? 82 to 88. Kaya kung may channel 6 dito sa Metro Manila, you can listen to the audio of that TV on your TV. FM tuner.
Which actually, is parang TV 5.
Yeah, actually, naririnig ko yan sa Iloilo kasi, ano yung tawag yan? They're on channel 6. I think GMA, no? Oh yeah, GMA is on channel 6 ata.
Yes. May question dito si ano si Dr. Don Louis San Victores, an electronics engineering professor sa Central Luzon. Yan ba yung question sa multiple programs sa TV or CAS, Boss James? Without elaborating, I would say 90% has something to do with your question. And it can easily be rebutted. Kahit natutulog tayo, tanungin tayo dyan, masasagot natin yung lima. Tama ba?
Because
the questions raised in Congress is based on misunderstanding. And I think the top engineers of ABS-CBN were not included. Not invited, but they were not included in the ABS-CBN team who went to Congress. Because there was not even one technical person from the ABS-CBN team when they were trying to defend their application for renewal. It's a pity because it's an opportunity for the engineers to shed light and clarify misunderstanding on matters that deals with technical operations.
Ayan.
Now, of course, yung mga congressmen, may advisor silang mga engineers. May advisor sila. So that's why they were able to poke those questions. So nakakainis lang na walang technical resource person na dinala si ABS-CBN. I think it's a mistake by the legal team.
Ito, may tanong na kung pag nag-shut off daw ba ang analog? Ask ko lang, yung analog sa UHF, once na mag-shut off ang analog, pwede daw ba siyang i-allocate sa new players?
Ulit-ulit ang question. May binasa kasi kung question ni Joey Josh eh.
Ask ko lang, yung analog sa UHF, once na mag-shut off ang analog, pwede ba siyang i-allocate to new players? Once na mag-shut off na raw ang analog, pwede raw ba siyang i-allocate sa new players?
Okay. Once the analog service in the UHF band has been terminated due to the analog shutoff, it is assumed that existing analog broadcasters have already shifted to digital TV. And the available capacity due to the technological benefit of digital TV, of course, there will be free channels, definitely. It will then be allocated by the commission based on existing rules and regulations and processes of the NTC. So let's put it simply. If you look at UHF, mag-start na lang tayo sa 21 kasi yung 14 to 20 para sa transitional yun eh. Mapapansin nyo puro odd numbers. At yung even are taboo channels. So in theory, you would have half of the existing analog channels available for digital TV. So bilangin na lang natin. So 21, 23, 25, 27, 29, 31, 33, 35, 37, 39, 41, 43, 45, 47, 49, 51. That's 16, di ba? 16. So in theory, all the even numbers, which is 16 or 15, would be for allocation to new players. So kung nakapila ka at yung first three nabigyan na si AMBS, nabigyan na si Aliw, nabigyan na si Sunshine, at nakapila ka number 4, di magkakaroon ka. Kahit number 10 ka sa pila or number 12, sigurado makakakuha ka. Di ba? In theory, when we count the available spectrum, and we're only talking about NCR.
Yes, ito, ito rin, mm-hmm. Sir. No? Follow-up question lang kasi ito. Actually, kanina pa itong tanong. But it's related din sa analog shut-off. Ayun, no? This 2023. Ba?
Kasi, yeah,
wow. Ano na yan? Sa ating yan, di ba?
Rolling dito man kasi yan, eh.
Yeah, according to NTC, it's a moving date talaga.
Oo.
Di ba according to
hindi pa defined. Kung yeah, defined pa siya, it should be announced na in a media blitz na so, kung saan eh cooperative na yung lahat ng mga networks in announcing just like the NHK when the final date of analog shutoff was already laid in place.
No, dapat KBP mangunguna. Dapat KBP mangunguna diyan. Dapat KBP mangunguna diyan. KBP and the other networks. Non-member stations. Sabihin yeah, natin yun.
Diba?
KBP and non-member stations like GMA.
Mm-mm.
It's so, more beneficial for the broadcasters to go to that migration and termination of analog because it would save them a lot of money operating two stations containing the same programs. Diba?
Mm-hmm.
So they could concentrate all of their resources to a single platform which is digital. Now, when it comes to the actual ASO, this would be a policy issue and the question should be raised to the DICT, not to the NTC. So that's the distinction. DICT would be the policy determinant and when it comes to the regulation, it's going to be the NTC. That distinguishes the two agencies.
Mm-hmm. So, ibig sabihin...
May ganon.
So, ibig sabihin, Sir James, it's the DICT who will decide on the date.
The ASO?
The ASO. It's a DICT.
Kasi it's a matter of national policy kasi.
In concurrence with ES. executive secretary. Kailangan may approval pa yata ni ES yan. So baka may EO. There's a possibility na baka e-executive order. Baka,
I don't think so. I don't think so because there had been publications by the DICT during the what was that event in February 14, Jay?
Yeah.
The Digital TV Summit.
DTV Summit.
The DTV Summit, they have already circulated the handbook for the digital migration of the Philippines. And then it contains the target schedule for the analog shutoff.
Okay. Ito, Sir James, ito tanong to.
Excuse lang ulit. Excuse lang ulit. Medyo nag-accumulate yung mga questions pero CR break ulit ako. Dali lang.
Alright. Sige, recap ulit tayo. Recap ulit tayo.
So, okay. So, we have already this dissected yung issue tungkol sa NUGP na sinabi ni Sir James na flatly sinabi niya na mali. In essence, medyo mali yung sinabi ni Sir James. And dapat naging circumspect ang NUGP when it comes to their statement. And dapat, and he also said na it's unfair for NUGP to brand the issuance of the frequency to AMBS and Aliw and Sunshine Media. So dapat it's unfair na wag nilang kargahan, kumbaga, hindi pwedeng kargahan. So
i-label mo ganoon ano.
Wag ganoon, hindi pwedeng kargahan yung pagbenta kasi nga it's a job of the NTC. Basically, trabaho ng NTC yun. So, I hope na it clarifies things. I hope na, excuse me, naklaro yung mga issue sa social media kasi, yun nga, pumalat talaga sa social media yung issue tungkol sa ABS-CBN na parang hindi masyado naklaro on the front of the NTC. While, nagsasalita si Director Cabarrios, excuse me, of course, mayroong mga ibang noise na sumasalo. And it's up to us to dissect the noise from the regulation kasi, yun nga, nagkakaroon ng confusion regarding sa noise na narinig natin and the actual regulations by the NTC. Ito, Sir James, ito tanong ko to. It's not here on social media. Yung binigay na PA sa advance was for simulcast until analog shut off. Ang nakalagay doon 2023. Pero we all know it's a moving date. Question, Sir James. So, ibig sabihin ba noon, dahil nga moving date ang shut off, advance media can utilize the channel 2 simulcast, analog simulcast, and channel 16, or utilize the channel 2 analog until the analog shut off, kung kailan man mangyari yon?
No. They can utilize channel 16 and yung channel 2 for as long as they have the permit. Now, when it comes to availing the use of channel 2 for the analog simulcast, that would be dependent on the decision of AMBS. They have the option not to even they have the permit. Diba? That's okay naman, diba? Parang you have the permit to operate a sari-sari store. Pero you did not open the sari-sari store. You have the business permit. Is it illegal? No. You have the permit, eh. You're paying the permit. But to actually operate it is an option. This is just an opinion, ah. I'm not saying that's what they're gonna do. But what I'm saying is, if they don't operate channel 2 analog, is it illegal? What do you think, guys? They have the permit, but they decide not to operate.
That's parang breach. Ano eh. Kumbaga para sa ano, binigay sa'yo yan, gamitin mo, kasi sa resources, kung hindi mo gagamitin, baboy na lang namin. Is that the case?
No, they were given 18 months to operate the network. 18 months,
okay. Ah, okay.
And 18 months is very tight, ah, to build a broadcast system.
True. Yes.
You have to take into account first the design.
Yes.
Because whatever design that they had in 2006 might not be the best at this stage.
Yes.
Second is the procurement process. Next would be the installation, integration, testing, yes, and commissioning. Yes. But before you arrive to that point pala, ng installation, system integration, commissioning, there's an importation process.
Mm-hmm.
And that takes 3 to 6 months already. Mm-hmm. So if you have 18 months, if they are able to muster all of their resources to bring everything to meet the requirement, they would only have around 6 months to operate based on the permit.
Okay.
Assuming they are starting from zero.
Okay. I-up ko lang yung provisional authority na pinost ni Attorney Trixie Cruz Angeles sa kanyang page. Sandali lang.
Hmm.
Kasi may nakapost, sige, nakapost yung provisional authority doon. It came from Politico, of course.
While waiting, basahin ko lang yung messages dito ni Joey Josh. Sabi niya, thank you, Sir James, for catering. Nababasa niyo ba yung questions?
Actually, hindi lahat. Sa stream yan, sir, no? Sa stream yan, sir, no?
Sa stream, can you read? Kasi ano, medyo maliliit yung text. Maybe it's better. Mas maganda boses niyo kaysa sa akin.
Hindi na tapos sir, baka sa stream. Baka, sa stream yata yan, sir. So I'll just go to the stream, ano? I hope I can catch that.
Okay.
Okay.
Ay, may isang tanong dito si ano. Ah, sige. Go, Jay. Go,
okay.
Go.
Joey Josh, okay. There can be a new player in the future. Is this, sir? Is this one? Meron pa.
No, yung thank you for catering to my thoughts, mga ganon. And then...
Okay. Sige. Ang tanong, based on your own expertise and foresight, matutuloy kaya sa 2023 itong ASO? Mukha kasing sa mga probinsya in Cebu, medyo konti pa lang ang stations na nagmamigrate. Sir James.
Okay, yung national ASO, definitely hindi mangyayari yan, which is simultaneous termination of analog nationwide. Mm. But for regional ASO, it's possible. So ano yung mga mag-regional ASO? Key cities. So you can expect NCR, Cebu, Davao, yan yung mga major. Kaya yan. Now, interestingly, if you shut down ang analog sa NCR, ang spillover niyan is up to Southern Luzon, which is Region 4A, and up to Region 3, and up maybe up to Region 2 and the Cordillera Administrative Region. Yan yung spillover nun kasi may overlapping coverage yung mga services, lalo na yung galing Baguio. They actually go up to Central Luzon na overlap din ng Metro Manila. So pagka shutdown mo ang NCR, nag-ASO ang NCR, most likely maki-carry over yung regions na na-mention ko, 4A and 3 and possibly CAR, portions of CAR and Region 2. So for okay. Cebu, damay na dyan ang Bohol. Although may spillover sila sa Leyte, I would not consider Leyte na madadamay doon sa shutoff na yon. And then for Davao, it's strictly within the Davao region.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So ito, I've already got, nakita ko na ito na, we have already got the copy of the provisional authority. Ayan, bat paki, ano lang, ayan. So ito, this is from Politico. So, ito yung provisional authority niya. So, ito.
BSD-0001-2022-TBC.
To be confirmed. So, ayun. So,
temporary. Okay, AMBS ba yan?
Oh, AMBS. AMBS.
Okay.
So, ito. Temporary permit to test broadcast is hereby granted to Advanced Media Broadcasting System imposed on address 2906. Paragon Plaza, Ilaya.
Ah, Paragon na.
Di ba dyan Ilaya si Mandaluyong yung...
Oh.
Oh, ma. Yeah.
Parang ka Ilaya yan.
Ayan. Ilaya Mandaluyong City. Conduct test process. Ito. Nature of service, analog TV, frequency channel 2, power 30 kilowatts, Location, Star Mall, EDSA Show, Boulevard, Mandaluyong City. Hours of operation, 7 a.m. to 10 p.m. Particulars of equipment, make type model NEC PCN 1800. Serial number TBD on purchase. Range 55.25 to 83.25 megahertz. VST, temporary permit to test work is effective from 6 January until analog shut off unless sooner revoked or canceled. It is understood that the operation of the subject registration shall be done in accordance with existing radio laws and regulations. So, what are your thoughts about this?
Kailangan na magaling na engineer ng AMBS.
Mm-hmm.
Eh, meron naman silang pambayad, di ba?
Mm.
So, yung permit na yan, like I said earlier, is a sort of compliance to be an occupant of an analog digital transitional band, which is the channel 14 to 20. So, parang it goes without saying that you need this permit also. Otherwise, there would be questions for your occupancy for channel 16.
Mm-mm.
Now, may nabanggit dyan na NEC type na transmitter na 1800. Nakalagay ba on purchase?
On purchase.
So, ongoing na yung acquisition yan. So, what I can see is that they will operate this based on compliance operation. So, any compliance operation, they will not be operating in high power, but just enough. Maybe 1 kilowatt. Maybe 1 kilowatt.
30 kilowatts nakalagay, sir.
30 kilowatts or ERP?
Well, walang ERP, sir. 30 kW power niya.
Power, 30 kW.
That's interesting. That's interesting because if they have a 30 kilowatt transmitter there, then I could assume the antenna configuration to be massive. Remember, this is channel 2 and the wavelength is quite long. So, if you could see my hand, that's more than a meter. So, let's say 1.5 or 1.6 meters for each antenna. So, if you have a large antenna panels, then the weight would be significant. Then you would need a big tower. Have you seen a new tower being constructed? Because the one in Paragon is already full for FM operations of AMBS. Unless they're going to terminate all of their FM to accommodate the VHF channel too.
Pero so sir, that's another sa Star Mall daw yun.
Sa Star Mall Elsa Show, sir.
Kaya nga, have you seen any new tower being constructed on top of Star Mall?
Wala.
As far as I understood, wala.
Wala. Ayun. And to construct a tower, it takes time.
Mm-hmm.
Lalo na with the load, the weight that we're talking about here. Considering an 8x4, so that's 32 antennas na malalaki. Ang bigat nun. Mm-hmm. So the tower should be massive enough to support the weight. And the typhoons, the wind loading, etc. It takes time. And I don't know if Star Mall, the building itself, is designed to accommodate a huge load on top. So we cannot speculate on these matters.
So, ito sir, ito yung order ng NTC.
So that's why I mentioned earlier they have the option not to use it.
Mm-hmm.
If they think it's not going to be beneficial to their intention to operate. And what they need to do is file a motion to the commission stating that they have decided that they will not operate the analog channel and instead concentrate to digital. That would be the contents of a motion to justify not utilizing what was covered by this permit. Nakakalibre ng consultancy sa akin si AMBN dito ah.
Wow. Yun nga eh. I mean, ito, nakita natin yung itong document na to, itong test broadcast permit na ito. Politico has not leaked yung, I think meron yatang isa pang pero hindi ko na alam kung yun nga ba yun, yung sa Aliw and sa Suara. So, pero, ay, hindi pala, ano pa, press releases pala yun. So, yun, sir, yeah, you've seen the document itself, yung probatory, yung test broadcast permit. So, I guess, yun na, it's...
Kumbaga, yeah, optional ba? Ganon?
Yun nga, hindi. I mean, naliwanagan na tayo dito kasi this is a document na only engineers can understand.
Ayun, oo. Okay, may pinapakita kang documents from ano eh, the next two tabs. What's the second tab?
Hindi, ano yan, yung order. Yung order yata. Oo, no order, yeah, ng AMBS. So,
Certificate of Public Convenience.
Ayan, yung application ng CPC. In the record shows ito, na, ano?
DTV, oh? Ah, this refers TV, to the application for Certificate of Public Convenience to install, operate, and maintain a digital television broadcasting station in Metro Manila filed by the applicant Advanced Media Broadcasting System Inc. on October 5, 2006. Tagal na. Ayan. The record shows that the applicant is 100% Filipino corporation, duly organized and existing under any and by virtue of Philippine laws, and was duly registered with the Securities and Exchange Commission with SEC Certificate of Registration Number ASO 91-196885 issued on February 11, 1984, a holder of a congressional franchise under Republic Act Number 11253. At present, applicant is also a grantee of various authorizations issued by the Commission. On October 5, 2006, applicant filed an application for Certificate of Public Convenience to install, operate, and maintain a digital television broadcasting system in Metro Manila following applicant's compliance with the jurisdictional requirements.
Wala na yan.
Iba na to.
Iba na.
Ito, PMSI. PMSI is... Ano, sino PMSI? Dream, no?
Dream.
Okay. So, inopost ng Dream yung ano nila, CPC nila. Pero ang ending, let's read... ano bang re-read natin dito, Red? 19? Start tayo sa 19? Or doon na tayo sa ano? Okay. It shall abide with all laws, rules, and regulations of the land. And
ito.
Yung PA.
22?
Finally, this PA may be subject to amendment, alteration, suspension, revocation, or cancellation when public welfare, morals, or national security so requires, or when grantee operates beyond its authorization granted. So ordered by the Commissioner Camaliel Cordova, signed by Edgardo Cabarrios and Dalila F. Deles, both Deputy Commissioners. So ano yung sabihin nun?
Yeah.
So they tried to operate, di ba? They filed an motion or application.
Nag-apply na sila na, meron na silang provisional authority.
Huh. Actually, may subjective portion dun eh. So di ba nakalagay dyan na can be canceled or revoked whenever public inconvenience.
It's in public interest ba? Or ano? Kasi ang sinasabi doon, public interest or kung nag-out of bounds na yung applicant.
Okay, yung public interest is very subjective. What is public interest?
Or national security, sir?
Ayun, national security definitely. Mm-mm. Subversion yun, di ba? Which is punishable criminally. Pero again, who will be the one to determine culpability and violation? I mean, you can put those words there, but do you think NTC will be the one to hold the hearing regarding public inconvenience, etc.? That is somewhat subjective, diba? There should be a permanent body that would ascertain if they have satisfied the good standing of public morals. Medyo mahirap yun, di ba?
Mm-hmm. Ito, Sir James, okay, ito.
Marami naman tayo nakitang stasyon na aksidente. nagkaroon ng mga ano ba yan, yung mga wardrobe malfunction or may nagmurang anchor or host. And that's already contrary to public morals. Diba? So who would ascertain the magnitude of the penalties that should be imposed? Had there been any? Really?
If they are member of the KBP, they could be sanctioned to penalties. Kung hindi sila member ng KBP, they could
then who?
Seek other legal means. Yun nga. Sino? Diba? Wala.
Wala.
Ito. Kaya nga sabi ko, medyo slightly subjective siya.
Ito, Sir James, ito pa, reaction lang dito. Ito, may article akong in-up dito. Ito. Ito, nakapost. Pa-up nga, at ito yan.
Sige.
Ito. Digital
before that, pa- yung KPR Galya. Galya ba? Galyo?
Galya.
Tito Galya, yes.
So, wala siyang technical, hindi niya sinabstantiate technically yung sinasabi niya kanina. Channel 10, wala.
Wala. Sinabi lang niya sa isang interview na pwede daw mag-apply ang ABS and kunin ng Channel 10 off the bat.
And then, no. That's without basis. That's without technical basis. And purely speculative. That's my conclusion on that one. Sige, tuloy mo yung ipa-flash mo.
Ito, yan. Then, ito, article from Politico, January 29, kahapon. Or kanina. Or kahapon, tama. Kasi 30 na pala.
Who is running this website?
Hil Kabakungan of the Abante Group.
Okay.
Abante Group. So ito, digital hiningi, pati analog binigay. Marichu Lambino, grant of ABS-CBN's former testimony bill can be challenged in court. So sinabi ni
I guess the highlight, the headline itself, this is a tabloid. And as a tabloid, they should not be taken seriously.
Ito, sabi nga, ito, they interviewed Attorney Marichu Lambino ng UP College of Communication. Sabi niya na ano daw.
What was the question to Attorney Lambino? So, let's start first with the question to Attorney Lambino. Attorney, di ba?
Attorney, yes. All of a sudden, a provisional permit to operate the biggest free channel, analog channel 2, was given to AMBS, now owned now by Planet Cable, that was not covered by the CPC, which was dated January 5 because that CPC is for digital TV. So that raises, and that the term, sir, taints the entire process. Why would you all of a sudden add on or annex the biggest free TV analog channel to a digital grant, she added. Lambino said like, the grant...
Like what I said earlier, it is predicated that when you use a channel in the band that is classified as an analog to digital transitional and simulcast channel, then naturally you have to take the VHF also, di ba? Yun yung nilay down ko kanina. Otherwise, hindi siya sa 16 nilagay. Pero 16 is the only available. So, AMBS is now predicated to operate a VHF channel also.
Ito. Sinabi rin ni Lambino na yung grant number 2 and 16 can be questioned in court since the law requires a notice and hearing to be held for accounts. The order was granted upon notice and hearing of a digital frequency and the order itself says digital TV. The next day they granted, they gave away the analog free TV channel to AMBS, which is not included in the hearing, in the notice, in the order. Lambino, however, said the petition in any case that it would be filed against NTC or AMBS is a party of interest in the matter. Or ibig sabihin, they are an interested party doon sa provisional authority na yon. In that case, that was Dream, pero wala na sila. So, ayun lang, Sir
James. My position on this one, like I said earlier, is that the quasi-judicial process of the NTC has been done in 2006, somewhere in that period. and every party had the opportunity to oppose, air their views, and to ask the NTC not to approve the application. So that process of public hearing had been done and complied with. They have satisfied the technical requirement, they have satisfied the financial requirement, and they were able to answer all the oppositions done by concerned parties. So that quasi-judicial process, in effect, is like a normal court proceeding, and the outcome becomes the foundation for subsequent decisions of the NTC to grant a provisional authority. Again, my opinion.
Okay, so again, I'll just take a little break muna sa discussion kasi mag-extra na muna ako. It's already past 1:16 a.m. Napasarap na iusapan natin. And I'm only contracted to do the show until 1:30. Joke. Wala namang kontrata. Walang kontrata. Ano lang, pagod na talaga ako.
Sige lang ako. We've run for 2 hours, 21 minutes, and 17 seconds. Yes, Red.
Yan. So again, Sir James, thank you again for showing this information to us, and sina Pat, Jay, and Kyle na ang bahala dito. Ako, I need to take a break.
You're a member of NUJP, di ba?
Hindi. No.
Ay, di ba? Kasi if you were, please extend my best wishes to them. Na lang.
May kakilala ako, sir. May kakilala kami. May kakilala si Pat. So again, guys, I'll be cutting off na muna sa inyo, pero do stay tuned, continuous pa rin ating discussion, and if you have any questions, send them down in the comments. Pakiramdam ko pamurninga na ito. Anyway, yes. Sige guys. Pamurninga na ito. So sige. Guys, right, thank you very much, and
sa kamay kita.
Okay, lagi muna. Okay, sandali lang muna. I'll promote my socials first. Of course, I'm a reporter at the Manila Times. So, RM Mendoza MT, checkmark, verified yon.
Yun, no, verified.
Nightmare APN for anime. And of course, Nightmare for Instagram. And of course, facebook.com/NightmareJournal or facebook.com/RedMendozaPH and facebook.com/RedMendozaTMT. So, ayun lang. So, again, good morning, guys. And
Good morning.
Take it away.
Alright, sige. Sige, okay. I will just entertain a few questions here, actually. Ang sakop ng NTC sa kanilang broadcast permits ay yung frequency and all, di ba? Tama ba na hindi nila sakop kung how long the station will operate from 12 a.m. to 12 a.m. The next day, ano? Hindi nila sakop yun, and also the call sign.
No, it's all under NTC.
NTC, yung coverage time nila, yung mga from kung bagay yung 24/7 channels.
Yes, it's mentioned in the permit. So it has something to do with the class of stations. So alam ni Pat yan, laging nagsisit in sa klasiko noon sa Mapua yan.
Ayun.
Each station is classified to, let's say, class A, B, C, or D. Pagdating naman sa FM and AM, meron din mga classes of station. So the class of station determines the number of hours you operate every day, at least as a guideline. Kasi before naman, nakapapansin natin nagsa-sign off mga station pero ngayon meron mga station na sa salinggo na lang sila nagsa-sign off. Merong
for example
ganon.
Yung channel 37 ba?
Tuloy-tuloy lang, di ba?
Tuloy-tuloy lang.
Which is interesting, if you check the PA, ano kaya nakalagay doon sa ano nila? Doon sa number of hours of operation. That would be interesting, di ba? So the question is, if you under-comply or over-comply, will there be a violation? That would be an interesting discussion. We have to gather all of the PAs and evaluate, diba?
And then we need to have someone with the legal aspect na related sa podcast industry. Kasi this is a legal matter talaga entirely. Pero interesting ano, so yun talaga ano, kasi we're addressing some questions here na kung ano, yun nga, pati sakop pa nila yung ano, yung broadcast times and all. Kaya may mga 24/7 na radio stations kagaya ng sa MBC, they operate 24/7, 'di ba? So they're on the different class. And yung call sign niya, what I understood from learning amateur radio, ham radio, thanks to Tito Pat. Ayan, kasi hindi na ako nakakagalaw sa ham radio.
Napati rin ako eh.
Wala ka lisensya. Paano tayo nag-iayon nyo ng lisensya?
Ninong Pat ka naman.
Oo, pero yun nga, pati yung TV stations, di ba? For example, ABS-CBN was DWWX. Hmm. Pati yun, sakop ng NTC yung regulation ng call signs, right?
Yes.
Okay, yun. So, basic questions na, ano, yun yung, ano, kumbaga, just to clarify.
Yeah, there's a standard naman kasi. I think if it's DZ, it's in Luzon. If it's Luzon DY, it's in the Visayas region. If it's DZ, it's DX, sorry. Tama DX. Ba?
DX, Davao, or Mindanao.
It's DX. In Mindanao.
Yes. And then so DW. Simply,
simplify.
DW Luzon eh.
DW Luzon na rin. Okay.
Yeah.
Ayun.
If you're going to check TV stations with DWWX, that was on TV2 that time.
Mm-mm.
May ayun, question si Angelo Tangunan. Sorry. How about the allocation for VHF? One shot off. Will it be able to use?
Sorry. FM. FM radio yata to? From
FM radio spec radio broadcast spectrum, particularly 76 megahertz.
FM, I don't think so. I don't think so. The most likely the government will have plans.
FM pala to. Sorry.
Yeah,
to utilize the vacated VHF frequencies to whichever will fit the benefit of the Filipino people. Kasi so ano ba yung mga example ng mga benefit na yan? Yung mga free wifi, yung dating experimentation ng TV white space.
Yes.
So hindi na siya magiging white space kasi magiging free band na siya. But then that's just one of the possible things to do. We wouldn't know what are the plans of the government once na freed up na yung VHF band.
Sabihin natin, marami pang pwede mangyari. Marami pwede mangyari.
Very interesting question, no? Kasi for example, if a transmitter purchased by Station X can be transferred to Station Y, kumbaga, ibibenta ko yung transmitter ko sa ibang station.
Pwede yun.
Pero I'm pretty sure maraming papers na iyaano dyan.
You just have to inform the NTC.
Yes.
Kasi nilalag nila yung mga serial numbers ng mga equipment na yun. Lalo na yung mga gagamit ng ano, ng airwaves.
Yeah, mostly RF emitting devices, sir, di ba? Kailangan ng
yung documentation.
Kasi ganun sa radio eh. Ganun sa two-way eh.
Oo, two-way pa nga lang, di ba?
Yeah, two-way. Ganun na kahirap yun eh. What more? Yun, so, ito kong lalaking transmitters, no?
But may question si ano, you know, si Don Louis San Victores.
Yes sir.
Sa stream. Ang sabi niya is
SFN ba ang implementation ng DTT networks on its full implementation? Nakalimutan ko na yung sinabi mo dati.
Ang sagot diyan is hindi lahat mag-SFN. Ang SFN ano ba ang, why would you use an SFN, Pat? Ikaw mag-explain.
Well, kung gagamit kasi ng SFN, it's one content yan. Para at least mas malaki yung network reach mo or...
No. It's not one content. It's one frequency.
One frequency. Sorry about that. Para one frequency, para lumawak yung coverage mo or you can use it as gap fillers. No? Tama, sir?
So you will be SFN, you will be utilizing a single channel or frequency to cover a large area that includes the dead zones, yung mga shadow areas.
Yes.
or a contiguous service area that has overlaps on various regions. So let's say NCR, katabi mo Pampanga, Bulacan, Tarlac, and if you have the same frequency allocation there, then you can utilize SFN to optimize your coverage. So, yes. But then again, not all broadcasters will have the financial capability to deploy a large SFN. So, it would be a business decision. SFN is a technical solution to optimize your coverage. Now, to do it or to avail of the benefits of that technological solution, it will be up to the business. It's up to the business decision of the network.
Follow-up question from JVD. Good day, M. Ordinary listener here. Ask ko lang kung bakit magkaiba ang frequency assignment ng isang TV station sa bawat local TV station every province. Why not going uniform na lang nationwide? Thanks. Which is interesting to answer, no? Bakit nga ba iba-iba ang frequency for each station sa every province?
Number one, because when the time that they applied for a particular channel to serve a particular service area, that is a region, they were able to avail of a channel that is available for use. So let's say in NCR, you have X channel, and then you never applied for Cebu and Davao for the longest time. But then when you are expanding and you now have decided to apply for Cebu and Davao, you found out that channel X is no longer available, you will be given channel Y or channel Z or channel W, whichever is available. That has been the scenario for analog before. Now, the question, I would add the question there. Why not the NTC have given a particular network the same channel nationwide? That would unduly benefit that applicant station to sit on frequencies that they're not utilizing. Instead, the NTC allocates frequency based on application and actual implementation. Otherwise, it would be allocated to the next applicant. So if kung hindi mo inapplyan, let's say, yung sa Surigao area, bakit magkakaroon ka ng karapatang gamitin yung channel na ginagamit mo doon sa main station mo, di ba? So we follow the rule na when there's an application and the spectrum is available, it will be given. And it doesn't necessarily follow that whatever channel you use on your first station will be the same for the second and the third and the fourth. That has been the situation in the analog before.
Oh, okay. Pero sir, ito, isa pang question, no? From Zim, kasi this is regarding with the ASO. Kasi nagiging moving date nga, right? So, the question is, ano po ba mga key factors kung bakit nagiging moving date yung analog shutoff and
bakit yes, moving
digital shutoff? Kung... Oh, digital switchover, sorry.
Oh, yeah, okay. Switchover.
Yeah, digital switchover. At posible po ba mag-gradual ang shutdown process like per region?
Well, number one is market forces. A certain region, let's say Pilitang region, kunwari ano, Sulu Tawi-Tawi region, will not be able to adapt as fast as NCR. So they would need more time before the people there could equip themselves with digital TV receivers. So the market forces in various regions would be the primary determinant. So, unless, of course, there will be intervention from the government. na instead of waiting for the people there to have the financial capability to switch to digital by buying receivers, for the government to accelerate the process, they could subsidize and distribute receivers in certain areas to reach a saturation point that would be easy to surmise that that area had sufficient digital TV receivers that warrants the termination of an analog service. Para na akong abogado nito magsalita. Iba talaga ang effect ng San Miguel.
Sir, so, wait a second. Ah, oh, tama. San Miguel leg pa rin. So sabi ko sa inyo, yeah, di ba mahaba ang inuman? Plug in.
San Miguel baka naman.
San Miguel baka naman.
San Miguel baka naman.
Andyan yung station ng San Miguel o sa, ano, sa show bar.
Parang alam po yan. Is it masquerading as CNN?
Sinabi yun eh.
Ayun.
The usual jokes.
Yes. The usual jokes. Si Ma'am Kashmir of ano dati oh. Nag-
DTV.
Hello. Yeah.
Hello, Kash.
Magandang umusta ka po. Okay, I think yeah, na naubos na.
We don't have any more questions here. Wala pa naman masyado. No?
So, naubos na yung tanong dito sa chat. How about sa inyo, Sir James?
Yes.
Nasagot ko naman lahat.
Mm-hmm.
Sagot ko naman lahat. So, anyway, kung may mga pending questions pa dyan, if there is none, or let's give opportunity for those who's listening, maybe 5 minutes to air their questions.
Yeah,
if there is none, then we can actually conclude this very interesting discussion.
Yes.
I really very informative discussion. So, ooh, habang hinihintay natin yung mga tanong ninyo, if you have any other questions, let's recap everything that has been discussed here sa ating mga ginagawa, no, dito sa buong usapan natin. First, we discussed yung details kung bakit nakuha ng Aliw Broadcasting ng Swarasug Media yung frequencies ng ABS-CBN, other frequencies under Amkara and ano, ABS-CBN, and bakit nakuha ng Advanced Media Broadcasting System, which is now owned by Manny Villar, ano, in that regard, yung ano, frequency per channel 2, and kung ano ba yung laman talaga, yung details ng temporary permit to of, ano, to test broadcast ng NTC sa AMBS, which is 30 kilowatts. They're procuring equipment for it, and then ang location nila sa Star Mall. We were also shown yung details about dun sa digital broadcast permit nila to operate on that frequency. So, things fell into place, and luckily for Manny Villar himself, talagang yung buong detail na sinabog ni Bilyonaryo to the point na nag-down yung site nila, and even Politico as well. Kasi that's ABS-CBN eh. That's the network that we've been used to know for 60 plus years. There's a sentimental value to that. And this is not the first time that ABS-CBN will get this kind of treatment na mawawala
siya. I never knew that you're that old already, Jay.
Sir, mahilig ko po sir, kaka-computer to, sir. Kaka-Wikipedia.
Ayun. So, ito, I see a very... Sige.
Okay, yes, go.
I see a very interesting question dito, no? Kasi... Ayan, yung frequencies po ba na ginagamit sa radio and satellite TV, NTC po ba nag-regulate noon sa dito sa Pilipinas?
Yung satellite, no.
Alam ko hindi.
Wait, cable, hindi. Pay TV is... Let's check the mandate again, ano? Kasi parang nabasa ko yung kanina.
Kasi ang pagkakalam ko neto, if you're going to operate an uplink, yung malaking dish na...
Uplink ka siguro.
Yeah, uplink. Kailangan mo ng permission yan. Kasi you're going to operate an uplink.
Ang nakalagay lang dito, regulates and supervises radio and television broadcast stations, cable antenna television, and pay television systems. Walang binanggit na satellite TV. Satellite TV meaning yung mga malalaking dish.
What is satellite TV?
What is satellite TV though?
No, you still have to secure a permit sa NTC kasi you're going to use an uplink and a downlink frequency.
Yes.
And the NTC is a regular member of the International Telecommunications Commission and the World Radio Council that discusses the various frequencies being used. So sort of an international coordination because when there's a satellite service, it transcends political boundaries. It goes to beyond the borders of a particular country.
Okay.
The service can be obtained.
Ayun lang, sir. Okay. Let's have an example. So this cable channel A, which is broadcasting from Singapore and wants to set its foothold in the Philippines, has already contacted a supplier, kumbaga, a partner dito sa Philippines.
Yeah, partner. Oh.
To initiate the operations. Then bibigyan nila ng parang device ba? Ano, tama ba? Do they give a device to the ano? Kasi di ba, for example, si cable channel
Is that the IRD? Yung decoder?
Yun, parang decoder na ano, uplink, downlink.
Yeah, kailangan mo yun, i-register sa NTC yun, nasa decoder.
Ayun.
Alam ko. Ayun. Kasi downlink yan eh. Downlink yan, kailangan yan.
And for example, we're broadcasting as channel Y, ano, dito sa Pilipinas. Then we want to broadcast to Singapore.
Yes.
So, permit pa rin yun, ano?
Kasi uplink naman yun.
That also applies to state broadcasters, right?
Lahat.
Okay. Mm. Interesting. Okay, let's look at the other questions that we have. Ano?
Singit ko lang. Yung radio, anong radio? Kung two-way, kailangan din yan. So technically,
yes.
Kasi anything that emits RF, di ba? Anything that emits RF, kailangan din yan sa NTC.
Okay.
Yung camera ko naman nawala.
Yun lang. Okay. So, let's go to the other questions. Kapag ba ang digital, kapag digital na lahat, by possible ba na 16 by 9 na lahat or 4 by 3 pa rin? Kasi 4 by 3 pa rin ang iilan. Ito. The thing about 4 by 3 and 16 by 9. I believe the net, what I see is network, the networks will still decide kung anong resolution ng broadcast nila. If it's 4K, HD, depende po yan sa SFN nila, tama? If this is digital.
De, tsaka kung ano, yung capability na mismong ano nila, mismong ano, equipment. Network mismo, yung equipment nila, yung playback.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yung playout, yung
production din.
Yeah, yung production TOC. What do you call TOC?
TOC. Technical Operation Center.
Yeah.
Okay, ito, magandang tanong to. Yes, eto po for clarification. Bakit kailangan po ng franchise to operate a digital broadcast service or PTV satellite? Unlike sa mga small cable operator na di na kinakailangan ng franchise to operate, kinakailangan din yata ng mga small cable operators to have their own franchise to operate.
Di kasi ang ano yung ang cable industry kasi, di ba? Sama may EO. Regulated na sila eh. May EO. May EO.
No, it's very simple. Do not complicate. Broadcasters uses free to air or they use airwaves. Cable do not because their service is passing through directly sa cable.
Mm-mm. Cable antenna so, television, sir, no?
Yeah.
No, CATV means cable television.
Okay. Ayun, kasi nakalagay din sa mandate cable antenna television yung ano talaga ng ano mandate na isa sa mga nire-regulate ng NTC. So tama for clarification din yan.
Ayan.
Okay. Sige. So, okay. Ayun, ito may ano. Tingnan ko muna yung question bago ko banggitin ha.
Okay.
Oo, okay. So for example, may VHF 10 sa Bulacan. Ito, according to kay Kit San Antonio, no? May VHF 10 na sa Bulacan. So, in short, hindi pa, no? Yung sinabi ni Mr. Galia ng democracy.net.ph na ay, well, to give merit to them, isa sa mga promotor ng BAS, yung broadband signal test na independent, ano? Although you have to use an app for that. Sige. Moving back, let me read the question in full. About sa VHF 10 na sinabi ni Mr. Galia na available daw for ABS, I think hindi siya pwede dahil yung VHF na ng GMA sa Baguio ay abot sa Bulacan. Mag-overlap kung mag-broadcast sa Metro Mega Manila, mag-host definitely ang GMA. Your thoughts po?
Even without that, I oppose that. I think that's wrong because it's unsubstantiated. There is no technical basis, no merit at all to use Channel 10 to alternate for the previous service being offered by ABS-CBN.
Mm-hmm. And we are on the NTSC system, no, sir?
Yes. NTSC, yes.
Okay.
So that kind of statement creates intrigues and confusion. So that's why I'm asking if there is a technical justification or any basis at all in science.
Okay.
Okay. Sige, tignan natin.
There's another question, no?
Go pa.
A page, the roaming historiador.
Yeah, okay. The roaming historiador. Let's go with yeah. that. Wala pa bang word kung kailan magbibigay ng generic set-top boxes para sa mga low-income families para mapabilis ang DTV migration? Nabanggit pa to before.
There had been no specific mention by the government that they will be giving out free receivers. Now, at this stage of the pandemic, what do you think would be the backlash to the government if they decide to give away set-top boxes? For sure, you will hear something.
Hindi pinapriority, hindi pinapriority yung pagkain, pinapriority yung ibang mga bagay.
Correct. So even if the government desires to subsidize these receivers for the viewers, for public service, you will still hear negative statements related to the pandemic.
Yes.
Tulad ng Dolomite Beach na yan, the budget has been allocated ahead earlier than the pandemic. So it's a matter of execution. If you do not spend or transfer the budget for the Dolomite Beach to healthcare, then you would be subject to a graft case. Kasi that's a budget specifically for a purpose. By transferring it or reallocating it to other purposes is already a violation of the graft rules. Diba? Parang inutusan ka na nanay mo, bumili ka ng, ano, bumili ka ng bigas. Pag uwi mo, nakita. Ang dala mo, munggo.
Wala.
Okay.
Okay, I've been reading some questions at the back. Kasi, bumabagsak na naman pa rin tayo sa conditional access system eh.
Hindi mo tapos yung cast na eh, no?
Oo oh, eh, ang dami na tanong about this. But, sige,
alam nyo kung paano matatapos yung issue sa cash, dagdagan nyo yung H na sa dulo. Cash.
I-post yung mga post yung mga GCash number niyo man lang diyan para ano. Sheesh!
But going back to the question, no. Ito.
Ayun sige, let's go with that. Nakapag-decide na po ba ang NTC sa cash system?
Hindi. Wala pa namang pinapatawag na technical working group for conditional access system ang NTC. Yun ang simpleng sagot lang doon.
Yun. Para matapos na yung issue sa cash na yan.
Oo.
Antayin nyo, pag nagpatawag, umaten kayo, di ba? Pag nagpatawag, umaten kayo kasi published naman yun.
Yeah. Reserve sa TC pa, hindi matapos-tapos yung issue sa conditional access system na yan.
Magbibigyan naman kayo magsalita doon sa mga public hearing.
Yes. Public hearing, ayun. So it's just a matter kung paano nyo babantayan yung mga announcements from NTC.
Give us a floor.
Kasi mahirap naman kasing ang daming sinasabi sa social media. Pero when the proper forum comes, you don't join to air whatever opinion. So by default, you have forfeited your right to air your sentiments pag gano'n. Meron naman public hearing eh. Magkakaroon ka ng pagkakataon magsalita.
That's the proper forum pa.
Yes.
Correct. And DTV Pilipinas has always been there.
Yes.
Diyan kami. Diyan tayo.
Oh. Kilala yes, na nga kayo sa NTC.
Diba? Star na tayo eh.
Yeah, I guess 10 minutes. Wala na. I see no more. Ah!
Meron pa. Meron pa mahapol.
Oh, may mahapol. May mahapol.
Wait,
this
lang
is a suggestion. This is a suggestion, I guess.
Sige nga. Ano, entertain natin.
Sige, let's put it up.
Instead of giving free setup boxes by, why should, by hindi ko maintindihan yung tanong, why should we lower to 200 pesos or 100 pesos? Wait lang ha.
Why not lower?
Oo. Ang factors din sa digital migration is di pa po affordable ang pagbili ng setup boxes. Okay. Tama naman. Valid. Ang presyo ng mga setup boxes is lower than 1,000 pesos. The ones that you attach to mobile phones, less than 800, 900 pesos.
650 yata ito.
Discount, sa mga discounted ba?
Ayun.
Does this even help?
Well, by reducing the price to what he was saying, 200 to 100, then definitely there's going to be a government subsidy.
Mm-hmm.
Diba? So again, we go back to the aspect of the possible intrigue when if the government implements this kind of approach.
Mm.
And imagine, you cannot buy any receiver for 200 to 100 pesos. The power supply alone would be even greater than 100 pesos. And you have tuners, MPEG decoders, remote controls. So, the cheapest siguro, or that the boxes can go down, is around 500 to 450 pesos. But that's buying it directly from the factory. And the factory doesn't sell retail. They sell in volume. So if you can find 10,000 friends who's going to buy, then you can place 10,000 units of order.
Mm-mm. Tapos wala na, no? Kumbaga kasi di ba sa mga middlemen may tubo pa, eh, no?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Logistical support, yes. Di ba? Mm-hmm. You have to transport the devices, you have to market it.
Tama.
May cost of importation pa.
Importation. Tapos ano pa, siguro, i-factor mo pa yung pang service.
Yes.
Hindi rin yung biro magpaano ng service, ha? Yung mga pa-repairs, hindi biro yan. Kailangan din extra parts yan, tsaka ano, time, training.
May magandang tanong dito si Earl Formanes. Sabi niya, reliable or serviceable pa rin ba ang DTT broadcasting in the next 10 years knowing na tumataas na ang demand in other digital media broadcast services, video on demand, internet, etc.? So it's referring to Netflix, Disney, Amazon. Well, I am inclined to believe that broadcast will still be significant greater than 10 years. The major advantage of broadcast is that it's free. And that's part of the mandate of the broadcasters. It should be free, accessible to all people. The rise of internet TV and other platforms that serves a form of pay television, actually. Those are pay television because they have subscription. The appeal of those kind of service is because you are able to access premium contents. And those premium contents are not usually available on free-to-air service. So, to make the distinction, people still watch free-to-air. But if they want to watch specific preferred content, then they switch to the subscription-type service, internet TV. So they would coexist.
Mm.
Now, if it's 20 years from now, then my answer would be different. But since you mentioned 10 years, I would say broadcast would still be significant.
Mm-hmm.
And the question I have is, are you willing to pay, let's say, 100 pesos for your free-to-air TV today? If your answer is no, then that justifies what I've just said.
Well, simply put, sir, free to air yan. So therefore, yes, it should be ano. The other commentary that we have is, ang dami ng providers ng mga over-the-top services, Netflix, Disney Plus, and then we have the iQIYI and the Bilibili, and then
yeah,
ano ba, HBO Go. So
Peacock, Discovery Plus,
Paramount Plus, Discovery Viva Plus, Viva Max, oo, Pop TV.
Yeah,
so,
Viva Max. Ah.
Kung nagpalata ka naman kagad. Viva Max, ha?
Bakit? It's a competing service.
Ano ba pala?
Mahalo ko nga naman.
Ano na kasi mga ads na nakikita kong yun. Nagka-car wash, mga ganun.
Ah, okay.
So how many services that we have? So, hindi na bilang, lampas na sa bilang sa kamay yan.
Oh, lampas daliri na yan.
Lampas daliri na. Counting na yan. Para tayo nagbayad ng cable ng lampas sa ganung beses.
Oo, oh, ganyan nga.
Diba? Oh, sure.
Buti pa dati, isa lang yung provider nun eh.
Diba? Oo. Well, monopoly has its ups and downs. Yeah, pero yung the fact that decentralized na yung ano, streaming, and everybody wants to put a value on anything na ano, everything, well, it's inevitable that we are victims, all victims to capitalism. Shing. No. Eh, magbabayad ka ng cable na 10 pesos eh. Paano yan?
Like, syempre, ang advantage din naman ni kasi. Na advantage rin naman ng over the top. Kung kami naman yung mga no commitment yan eh.
Tama, makes sense. Monthly, yes.
Monthly, pwede ka magbuo, no? Bundle lang isang taon, pero may ganun.
Or pwede mo i-bundle. Buti nga, may mga partnerships, mga tie-ins. Eh. Bundle yung mga OTT sa internet bill, sa cable bill, which is good, which is a plus. Pero, of course, there's still charges.
Pero may mga hindi naman gumagamit ng anong tawag dito na mga OTT. Isa na ako dun.
Baka Netflix.
Wala.
Okay.
Spotify is counted as OTT, tingin ko counted naman yun. Yun
it
lang
ang is OTT yun. OTT
yun lang yung subscription ko. Dahil kasi, may gumagamit sa amin, so I got the family plan. Yun.
Oy, nice. Oo. Ako naman sa end ko, YouTube premium ako. So I pay YouTube like 129 a month. Para walang ads. Kaya nga, ngayon ko lang nakikita yung mga ads ni ano, kung sino man senador yan na kandidato ulit, di ba?
Oo.
Ayun, sir, may nakita ako sa stream ninyo. Si Angelo ba yun? The feasibility of IP multicast as an alternative method of free and accessible digital IPTV over OTT or web-based.
Multicast instead of OTT.
Yeah. What is multicast, by the way? Parang, it's technically like your IPTV service.
Oo. Nabayakan din
sa broadcasters, tawag namin dyan, broadcast IP.
Yes. It's technically like your IPTV service, but through IP. And may gumagawa naman na yan eh. Signal is having IPTV service. Na through multicasting din.
Converge. But yeah.
PLDT. Si Converge, si Air Cable, di ba kanila?
Meron si yung ano, Vision. Tsaka
Vision,
Air Cable.
Ano,
Anyway, eto. Buti na nga lang daw, uso ang prepaid sa DTH.
Well, ano yun eh. Siyempre, ano na yan. Magbabayad, babayad ka ng receiver din kasi. Kaya ganoon talaga.
One plus ang receiver for that. Anyway, since sinabi nga daw kung ano mag-ano, what in the next 10 years, sir, balita ko may bagong generation na ng isdb-t in the works, ah.
No comment.
Ayun, kasi nag-publish na si NHK about that. So, antayin na lang natin. It's very early stages pa naman. So, wala pa information.
Announcement pa lang naman talaga sila eh.
very early stages pa naman, so antayin natin kung ano yung resulta nila about that.
Tapos sa so, US may next gen.
Yung bago
yeah,
na
next
ano,
gen
no?
TV na oh, ano, ATSC, ATSC 3.0.
Oo.
Yeah.
Tawag nila doon next gen.
Na tinutulak ng Next Start saka ng ano sino ba yun, Next Start and Fox? Fox Broadcasting ba?
I think so.
Ayun.
Anyway, so yeah. I see no more questions naman na. And magtatatlong oras na tayo.
Pero sige, ano magiging what do you see in the next 10 years? Saksahin yung mga perspectives din siguro, aside from Sir James. Hmm. Sa ating tatlo, ano yung nakikita nyo in 10 years? Sa kung magiging relevant ba DTV or next 10 to 20 years? Ano kaya?
Nanonood na ako ng anime sa Bilibili. Patay na yung TV dito sa place ko.
So in my end, as I have a TV rin naman, I rarely watch DTD unless kung balita.
Oo, we all except sa balita. Balita na sa internet na eh.
Sa even GMA
streaming 24 hours on TikTok.
Oh.
On TikTok. Ano?
I'm still a TV guy. Alam niyo sa
TV, siya TV guy. So, ang makikita ko in 10 years is more of ano na lang. Mas more players and then integration of AI.
AI. So, in short, in the next 20 years, yung si Ding Dong Dantes, may litrato yan, ginawang NFT.
There will be always incorporation of AI na. Mm-mm. Tsaka interactivity rin talaga. Parang ngayon nga may HBBTV na, but you know, that's not here in the Philippines.
We have, okay, in 20 years, we may have television sets that are customized for our needs, that are valid with our confirmation biases. Diba?
Diba?
Algorithm, okay, guys!
Oo. Yun po lang, diba?
I think we've spent a lot of energy na in this regard, ano, si Sir James ay ano na, no? Ayan, he's having his shut eye moment na. Just the last few words.
Well, I hope this ngayon, no? This is a very informative session, by the way. Dami ko yung natutunan, totoo lang. Yeah.
Let's download this whole recording, hati-hatiin natin, tapos i-feed natin, kasi ganun mahilig ang tao eh.
Yeah.
Puno ng ganito ang TikTok natin if we have one.
We have TikTok ha, may TikTok tayo.
Mag-edit ng video?
Meron tayong TikTok pero hindi ko masyado pa na-utilize. Pero meron content ng TikTok.
We will have to split every bit and piece of our conversation here because we have we did our best in catering to everyone and we did the best for ourselves to answer all the questions, all the speculations. Barilan ng idea talaga ito. Yeah. And I'm really happy to be part of this conversation. So, yeah. Si Red, nasabi na niya kung saan siya makikita. He's reporting at the Manila Times.
I would like to thank Sir James din, no?
Yes, especially Sir James. Salamat po, Sir James, for bestowing your knowledge to us.
Thank you, guys. It's always a pleasure. Maganda yung mga ganito na discussion. I'm sure kung meron mga
naghahabulan na yung questions.
O dalawampu na nanood sa atin, pero yung dalawampung yon would spread the right information to other people. And by having the right information, it's a sort of contribution to nation building na rin.
Yes.
Let's eliminate the evils of fake news.
Disinformation, misinformation, deliberate distraction.
Ah, may pahabol.
Sige,
okay.
This is about emergency warning broadcast system, sir.
That so must
the
be.
Question is EWBS is still in the dry run process and mandatory service for all digital TV receivers.
There will be a test this year. There will be a test this year.
All right. Okay. Thank you for that.
Bantayan natin
yan. Okay, Sir James, saan namin kayo makikita?
I have my Facebook, which is my name, James Roddy Santiago. I also have my YouTube channel wherein I post about technology in broadcasting. And lately, I have returned to my old passion of drumming. So I've been uploading drum covers So I'll be more busy on putting more drum covers on my page sa YouTube. But you still have the opportunity to access the other technical broadcasting lectures that I have uploaded there. So that's about it for me. I don't have, well, I have a Twitter, but I forgot about yung handle ko. I have an Instagram that I barely touches. So it's more of Facebook and YouTube. Thank you. Don Luis and Victores, schedule lang natin yan. So I have already an invitation to drink after the pandemic. I don't know about you guys.
San ba? San ba?
Wala pa eh, pero sa send me a private message, Don Louie.
Okay. Jay, saan ka okay. naman?
Jayagonig.xyz. I'm on my 98th episode. Mag-record ako bukas.
Yun, no?
No, yun, no. 98 so, podcast episodes.
Road to 100.
Road to 100 na talaga to. Walang ano. Dati, I was expecting na yung Road to 100 ko matatapos last year eh. Hindi eh. But aside from that, animecorner.me where I'm going to manage actually tinatapos ko lang yung news recap ng mga VTubers ngayon kasi doon na talaga ako eh. Doon na talaga ako papunta eh. By 20 years from now, hindi nyo na ako makikita sa ano na nanonood ng TV, nanonood na ako ng VTubers, sa kanila na ako kumukuha ng information. Yun, oo. And of course, meron akong binili na leche plan na asset pero hindi talaga ano sa akin yun eh. Pero leche plan siya eh. Okay, and yes, anchor.fm/keepsakes for my podcast. So yun, Kyle.
So wala, kung may YouTube channel ako, pero yun lang yun, it's more of my interest lang talaga.
May high quality videos si Kyle.
I do high quality videos lang, 4K. 4K yung mandatory sa akin.
4K game? Lang naman.
O game.
4K. Then, 4K content lang talaga. 4K, basta I shoot in 4K. That's the minimum resolution.
May gimbal ka ba?
May gimbal. Yeah, I do have one.
Okay, mag-usap tayo minsan. May gagawin tayo.
Ayun, oh.
No? Ayun, oh. Ayun,
oh. Yun, oh. Yun, oh. And Pat?
Ayun. I'm still nakatambay sa 144.700 megahertz.
Thank you, Earl Formanes. Sabi ni Earl Formanes, nagpapasalamat siya sa atin.
Ayan.
Salamat din. Yeah. Salamat sa iyong pakikinig at sa pakikinig.
Informative and interesting discussion. So, yeah.
Makikipagtalakayan. Ayun.
Please subscribe to my YouTube channel and yes, to the channels to of Jay, DTV Pilipinas
Thank
for
you.
More updated information that will be coming in the future.
Basta ang DTV Pilipinas naman can be seen on all social media na.
Yep.
Facebook, Instagram,
and soon in SMNI.
Uy. Yung libro ni Sir to.
Pakita mo nga yung libro niyan. Ayan, ako wala ako niyan eh. Pakita mo nga yan, Pat. Wala akong, ako wala akong copy niyan eh.
Ito, isdb-t handbook for broadcast engineers.
Ba't nga pala di ako nakakuha ng ganyan noong DTV Summit?
Ayan, sign ni Sir James yan.
May pa-autograph na oh.
Ngayon, no?
Rare na yan.
Yeah. Nahulog nandito.
Sana magkaroon din ako
dyan. YouTube, yung ano ba yan, Twitch? Parang hindi namin kaya mag-Twitch.
Hindi, we can all actually stream on Twitch. I don't know, we can by this time.
Pwede tayo mag-cross, ano, pero I think our content DTV is strategy PH Minecraft?
Oo, DTV PH Minecraft. Tapos tatayo tayo ng replika ng mga transmitters.
Pwede.
Ang baga ka sa bayad ng Minecraft server, sige.
Oh, mga na Minecraft kasi si Sir James eh. And you know,
you can buy the digital handbook for Filipino engineers or actually for broadcast engineers, the one that has been shown by Pat through Amazon store. You can order it online. I think there's a promo now, there's a discount. So I'm going to buy one for myself too.
So again, handle ko sa Twitter is at PBCNX. Inactive. Pero ewan ko, ang daming nagno-notify sa akin. Nakikita ni Jay kung anong nagno-notify yung sa akin.
Twitter ko din, ano eh, hindi ko na kinagagamit masyado. Powell tweet na, it's just nonsense. Plain nonsense lang.
Kaya, puro, it's isang ibon yung napalagi nagno-notify sa akin. Kilala mo na kung sino yun, Jay.
Isang ibon? Ang alam ko lang, text fire eh.
sabi na ni Sim, libre daw sa Shopee na oh.
So sana meron libre sa Shopee. Oh.
Hopefully meron for broadcast engineers, yes.
Mm-hmm. Kaya Shopee, Lazada oh.
Yeah, pero maganda pa kay Amazon eh. Ayun, Twitter ko ya, tapos yun lang sa 144 and then ayan, just follow our page DTV Pilipinas sa sa Facebook.
Nga pala, no, this is...
At i-follow nyo yung kay Sir James na, ano, na YouTube channel.
Oo, follow niya, no, follow niya kay Sir James. This is the first broadcast of DTV Pilipinas for 2022 and we're reaching the Lunar New Year. Kyung Hee Hot Sai and...
Naku, magiging busy ako nito.
Tikoy!
Tikoy na.
Tiyo natin.
Tsaka paputok na yan.
Oo.
Tiyo natin. Ah, hindi, bawal paputok.
Bawal paputok.
E di yung ano, yung mga dragon, yung dancing dragons.
Ay, wala nga, bawal nga. Sabi nga ni Mayor Isko, bawal.
Nga pala, no?
Nga pala, kasi nga pala COVID, oo.
Ayun. Anyway, so yun.
Sige, that would be it for every one of us on behalf of Fred Mendoza. Of Mr. Engineer James Roddy Santiago, of Mr. Kyle Ferencio, Mr. Patrick Chin. This has been Jay Agonoy with DTV Pilipinas. Have a great weekend and stay safe.
Mm. Get vax na din kung kaya. Get vax kung booster. Go na rin.
Yan.
So wash your hands. Always keep your distance and stay safe.
Mask din.
Mask din, syempre.
O, tama, syempre mask. Ba't ko nakalimutan yung mask mo?
sige, salamat. Pakikipagtala ka yan.